them, I didn't know for them. I said, was it, had your name on it? Did you get it?
I'm trying to find out.
Was it something private?
No. No, it's fine. Going again. All right, we're back.
Okay.
We're back. I'm sorry, chat. Like, I don't know. Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
Let's see. Careful. Oh, it is! Got it!
What is it?
Holy crap, boys! Oh, a huge collector's item.
This
is a collector's item.
What's
this, valuable? This is a PewDiePie cup. This
what does
is
that mean?
PewDiePie. He's the
PewDiePie.
Biggest.
PewDiePie.
PewDiePie.
What does that mean?
PewDiePie.
Is it music? Oh, a YouTuber. Oh.
He's a YouTuber. It came, boys. I'm excited. Yeah. Look at that. That is nice.
Where did you order that from?
This is sick.
I don't know what that is.
G Fuel. This is my G Fuel shaker cup. Holy shit. G Fuel. I had so much G Fuel. Whoa. It's energy. See how energized I am?
Like
dude, we got all of them. We got all of them.
Yes, you.
This is peach mango. I got a peach mango.
I was going to look at it.
I got a peach mango.
No, to read it.
Cherry.
Yeah, but he's doing this.
We got a sour cherry. What else? Lemonade. We're gonna see if that's any good, the lemonade. Where's this one? Okay, we got cherry limeade. This is gonna be an interesting one.
Easy.
It's gonna be an interesting one. Sherbet. We got a rainbow sherbet.
Imagine.
Holy shit, no. What is this one? The blue ice.
Yeah, if you read the fine print, then understand what's going on.
Blue ice, what is this? Oh, Fazeberry. We got a package of some phase variety of flavors. I have a huge variety of flavors.
Oh my gosh.
I got a huge variety of flavors. Shaker cup.
How do you take care of that? Just
this?
Mild soap and water?
Yeah, mild soap and water. That smells super good. Now, the.
Direct from the manufacturer.
You know what's cool about this?
What?
You know what's cool about this? Let's see. Let's see. All right, we have to go in here. It glows in the dark. This is why this one's awesome. It glows in the dark. That's why this one's the best. That's why PewDiePie's is the best. I had to show them it glows in the dark.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
It's luminous.
The whole thing is.
One of the words is called luminous.
Yes. Dark boys.
Yeah.
It's my sip of cup.
Be careful with it. How sturdy is the plastic? I mean,
this is a collector's item.
Or even if it's not plastic, it's something else.
Oh my goodness.
Your goblin cup got moldy.
I like these.
What?
Reminds me of sports.
It's Gucci.
Some of it, too.
Gucci.
I'll wait till you come.
The stripes and things. Wow.
It's Gucci.
We're not in use.
It's not real Gucci.
Whichever one you want to have first.
This is the beauty. Well, I don't know if I want to drink that now because I had some this morning. Pretty wired.
You mean a previous mail.
Where do you buy those? 7-Eleven?
No, you can't buy it at 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the interweb.
Wow.
Yo, is...
Well, read the fine print there.
I feel like the Wi-Fi is working, but it's just really not. Why does it keep effing? I don't know. I'm on Wi-Fi. I'm on Wi-Fi. What's going on, Grandma?
Nothing much.
I just came to hang out for a little, but my...
This is a Sunday.
So do you have somewhere for me and my dog to stay?
Where is your dog?
Can we stay in this room?
I've got to move stuff out.
Let's see.
Just sit down and relax.
This is a lot of stuff in here.
He got rid of that dog. Why can't your father
Because it's my dog. She does not want Nelly here.
Will you come in here and sit here?
Because it's my dog. My dog has separation and gets out. Oh, this dog wants to be...
Your father doesn't have an animal anymore.
He does not want the dog there. He said...
Why?
He said no animals. Said no animals. Uncle Siggy would love to walk her. She's a very good dog.
I'm not saying she isn't a good...
Here.
The only thing...
I'm...
JJ's is 13 years old now. That cat. He's not afraid.
The dog... What? Okay. I'm just saying, Grandma. My dog's coming with me if...
I got a shovel and paper and you can pick up the poop in the backyard.
Yeah, the dog in the backyard. They will steal her.
I bet.
They will steal...
I bet they'll steal anything that's not tied down. Avocados. Catch him in my backyard, 911.
I gotta...
Why? What's the hurry?
You're doing fine.
The internet sucks. I can't stream. Can I...
Crash or what?
Yeah. The internet's slow.
You slept... Where'd you sleep? Okay? And Joshua slept in the bedroom.
Yeah.
But did Joshua... You think it's close?
I'm not using my family for content. I'm trying to find somewhere to live. Yeah, I don't know. Stream. I do this every day. It's just lagging right now, and people are getting upset. The people who pay my bills.
Why are they getting upset?
Because the internet's not so good.
Okay,
you feel me? I have to make them happy. If
I just paid the car bill. 555.
Oh!
I paid twice a year insurance on that car.
Grandma,
$99.
Grandma's mining Bitcoin.
Sigurd helped me out with the bill.
Yeah, I did.
Cable.
You want me to pay some bills while I'm here?
No, I don't.
We'll pay your bills, Grandma.
I'm not after.
I'm gonna pay your bills.
I'm not after your money.
20 push-ups. Josh did 20. I don't want to do 20 push-ups.
Where's Josh?
Justin,
now?
Do some IR. Yeah. No, he's home. I'm gonna go see them soon. Here, I came to get my mail. I came to see what's going on.
Nothing's going on. Wait 6 months to a year. I just finally got the divorce papers. They have to see everything.
Wait.
My bills for 6 months.
Oh, okay.
Everything till they approve it.
I love you, Grandma. I'm right down the street.
Are they gonna feed you?
Maybe. Yeah, they have.
What do you mean, maybe?
Yes, they have food.
Are you on medication?
Marijuana. I'm smoking the marijuana.
You're so jumpy.
Oh, I drank G Fuel. I drank some of this today. I drank some energy drink today.
Yep, okay.
I'm going back to my mom's, the food. They're making. You should be not.
I got hot dogs and hamburgers.
She does.
We were gonna have. Fix Sigurd and fix a hamburger patty, and we're gonna. Right. And I got
make chat.
A salad.
Yes, Grandma. I love you.
But why do you have to?
Do you want me to make barbecue? I can make you barbecue.
I don't want barbecue.
Since you guys want some hamburgers,
you know, we have two: one for you and one for Uncle Cigarette.
What?
Go. I'll be back.
I've got two huge. We like sweet. The cabbage is cooked. The carrots.
It's fine.
It's okay, Justin.
I'm just gonna go back to my mom's for a little.
Why?
Why not?
You just got here.
Okay.
Yeah, you did.
I'm moving in. I'm moving in with you with my dog, but there's nowhere for me to stay. There's more room in my mom's.
Is the dog over there now?
Mm-hmm.
They're watching her?
Kind of. I have to be there to watch her.
What do you mean they're
kind of watching my dog?
I don't. What do you think happened to your dog?
It's my best friend. I love that dog. Let Grandma cook. Chat.
You brought her on the airplane?
Yes. She's right on my lap. She's a service dog.
What do you mean in your lap?
She's a service dog. She was right on my lap.
And she liked it?
Yes.
She's not afraid?
No.
Sit down. You're making me nervous.
I don't like sitting.
Why?
Because I sit all the time.
Why do you sit all the time?
Guys, I like to stand. Why am I so thin? I have a tape.
Do you eat?
No.
Why?
Because I can't afford it in Los Angeles.
You can't afford it?
Because I'm broke in L.A. In Los Angeles, I'm broke.
I thought you'd drive a car with a...
Grandma, that was 2 years ago.
You're not doing that?
I got fired from that job.
Oh.
I got fired.
Why?
Because a scumbag who I thought was my friend.
Yeah.
You have no friend, don't you know that?
I know I have
no
friends.
No, you don't. There's no such...
Let me tell you something. Let me finish. Someone who I thought was my friend got mad at me. They wrote an email. They wrote a letter to the company and said that I tried to sell them drugs and I hit them with my car and they lied.
Yeah, it was they ordered a complaint.
They lied. They lied. They lied.
Perjury?
Yes, they lied and I got fired.
Oh, boy.
You know what? I learned many, many years ago I have no friends.
You have no friends? Why?
No.
Why? Why? Tell me. Why do you have this philosophy?
Because they'll turn, it just like at work.
Yeah.
Walmart taught me, hey, I had no friends at work.
Why?
I call them users.
Snakes. You know, they're leeches.
Loan me money, loan me a couple of dollars, or give me a ride, or, you know.
They're leeches.
That's right.
A leech. Yeah. That's what they call them, Grandma. It's called a leech. They were leeching off of you.
Payday, you never get the money back. You give them a ride, and I'll pay you payday, you know. I have to work to pay insurance on that car.
Grandma's got leeches. Shit, that happened to me, too.
Yeah.
I had leeches, too.
Yeah, I told you.
It happens.
There's no such thing as a friend.
Oh.
Uh-uh.
No such thing.
So,
I don't trust anybody.
Grandma, you are very wise.
I of course I am.
They're roaches.
That's right.
They're nothing but roaches.
That's right.
You're absolutely right. Hey, you're speaking the truth.
So I'm trying. Your father said, oh, go to Century Village. I said,
isn't asking for a couple of dollars your whole gig?
What?
What do you mean it's my whole gig, Bearwall? Yeah, a couple of dollars here and there.
The only thing I want to get.
What?
Is the floor fixed and the roof in the bedroom.
Yeah. The city, you said the city's going to pay it, right?
I told you, they have rules. You should see all... Again, I don't know, I'm not knowledgeable on the computer. So, I got people to... they got the address and the phone number. I had to call Greenco Springs in Florida. And that's where your father had the attorney there, and I had Mr. Green as my attorney there.
Yeah.
To get the divorce, your grandfather wanted a divorce. And Linda lived here, I don't know how long. She had that bedroom, the air conditioning, the computer.
Expose
them.
Own
phone.
Expose them all, Grandma.
She never paid.
Never
one
paid.
Dime
one dime.
To live here.
Never paid a
I
dime.
I let her use a car to go find a job. And I told you, the first job your mother ever had was up at Young Circle. Do you remember she put you in that, I think it's a Baptist church daycare there.
I got kicked out.
No, she did put you in a daycare.
Yeah, but I got kicked out.
You remember that?
I got kicked out.
Huh?
Yes, I got kicked out. I went to Christian day school and I got kicked out.
And you went the one by the house where your father lived.
I fought some kid.
That one too.
I don't know, I probably got kicked out of that one too.
So, did you call? Why isn't your mother there taking care of your grandfather? He's in hospice in Gainesville, right?
I don't know.
Yeah.
What do you mean you don't know?
I don't know, Grandma.
Is Brent's father still here in the nursing home?
He's at their house right now visiting.
So he's still
what?
Alive, right?
Yeah, he's at their house. He's over there right now visiting. You should go say hi.
Is he here?
Yeah, he's
How's
here.
How's he doing?
He's doing well. He looks nice. He was good.
No, but they had him in a nursing home.
Oh.
Here. That's what your father told
Yes,
me.
Yes. He's in a nursing home here, Grandma.
You know where it is?
Nope.
But he's still over there now.
I don't know, Grandma, but I'm here to help you.
Did you see him?
Yeah.
Okay. Why do you talk so much?
Because I'm excited.
Why?
Why not? Why? It's Sunday. I could get excited.
You can do whatever you want to do. I'm not trying to tell you how to run your life. Am I trying to tell you how to run your life?
I get excited.
You don't need to get excited around
Hey,
me.
Grandma, if you need some extra cash, remember...
You remember...
Remember
who
those...
Who took care of you?
Remember those...
And Joshua.
Remember those Pokemon cards that you stashed away?
The what?
Remember those Pokemon cards?
Of course.
You should take those packages. You sell them on
eBay. They're still in the package.
Yeah, let me finish. You sell them on eBay. Guess how much one package is worth today? About...
I know that.
Oh, no, you don't know.
They're in the safe deposit box at the bank.
Here, look. She has boxes.
Joshua
here,
won't.
Look.
Oh, you better believe. I collected those.
She has, like, the original ones.
Absolutely. Let me show you what else.
Here, look. Got. Look at this. No, come here, look. This
Shit, I've got to get the book.
Oh.
I want to get this book in here.
Get me the book. Yeah, she knew about the Pokemon cards.
Of course.
She had them all. Bro, she has so many boosters. I forgot she has the boosters. I forgot she worked at Walmart. She literally has packs, like the boxes.
Except for one thing.
What did she not collect?
Not janitorial work, like working for
the... No. Stuff she collected.
Oh, we know about that. Get the book for it. She'd be right here. Hundreds and hundreds of cards. These come.
No, these aren't.
What is that?
No, I'm going to show you what I got. I don't know if they're of value now, but someday they will be.
Let me see.
Move this.
Did you open them up? I hope you didn't open them.
No. The Pokemon, or it's...
That binder.
Stop it. Some of these cards I've got here. No, this isn't all. I got plenty. This was in a package here.
Well, this...
No, don't take them out. I want to show you some cards I've got. I don't know how valuable.
Let's see.
Just wait. This. These.
Well, the thing is, I mean,
they're not Pokemon.
They're sports cards.
Where did you acquire these?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Baseball.
Maybe it's worth something. I don't know.
Not now.
Maybe.
Well, even right now, they may have some value.
Maybe.
Yeah. I said not now. They're not gonna be. Oh, there's more. There's plenty more. But they're in mint condition.
Yeah.
And I kept this package here. They were going to throw that package out.
Wait,
I don't know if it's any value, the package itself. Somebody might someday. But I straightened it out. It was all crumbled up.
I don't know anything about baseball. You would have to have like a rookie card. The rookie cards are the only ones that are really worth anything in the old rookie
like
ones.
Like I say, you see all these cards I've got? And I put every one of them in here in this book. I was going to buy a baseball.
Pokemon cards are worth more money, the old ones.
Oh, yeah.
No, seriously. Seriously. The older ones.
Yeah.
Unopened package can go for.
I don't know. See this at Disney World.
If you still have it in the packaging,
I do. Some of these cards were in with this, and these cards here. What are these? I don't know what they are.
Probably worth a quarter.
Okay.
I'm just being honest. Like the cards that are worth money are old. Like if you had a Babe Ruth baseball card from a long time ago, you're talking thousands of dollars. That's something you want to collect.
But I was gonna take them and put them in here, and I said no, I'm gonna leave.
Do you have Star Wars collectibles?
I'm leaving.
Star Wars?
No.
You don't have any Star Wars?
No, I said. I was going to take them out and put them in this book, and I said, no, I'm leaving them in the package.
I have a whole bunch of Michael Jordan memorabilia.
They're safe.
I believe it. Sure.
No.
That's a joke, though.
I said, no, leave them in the package.
Yeah, you're supposed to not open the package.
I didn't open the
package. No, but you opened the package. You can't.
No, I didn't.
When you don't open the package and you just leave it alone, the package is like mint condition there, and the package has no tear. Like
look here, they show that Sigrid and I watch. Maybe you're not much on TV, but it's
you watch the Antique Roadshow.
Good Morning America.
Good Morning America.
And they had. Wait a minute.
CBS.
They had a whole thing on him.
Oh, Ringo.
Yeah, Ringo. Yes. Just listen, when I went on my trip,
yeah,
you know where in London, did you go to London?
I've not been to London yet.
London, I was standing, I got pictures of the nightclub. What they call it, Sigrid?
Club.
What?
I got pictures of that.
Oh.
But it wasn't, they wouldn't let you go in. It wasn't open. All you could see was outside. They showed pictures and everything of Ringo Starr.
Yeah.
And there's still two living?
No.
One. He's the only one.
Three
are living. That's what I tried to get out of him this morning.
Mom. He was being interviewed. They were showing things. What was I supposed to do?
All right, here.
Nope.
Oh, I just got...
You're okay.
Get that.
You're fine.
Here's a picture, but I was standing... I got pictures there.
Nice.
Of that nightclub.
Nice.
With me standing in front of it.
It's in Liverpool.
England.
That's right. I went on a tour.
Yeah, Grandma went on a tour.
Richard Starr.
I did that when
It's in Liverpool, not London. Someone said.
Right.
Okay. So people who watch live there. People who watch my stream live there. There's people who live there. I don't know everything.
Okay.
But I learn.
He know. I ask him.
I'm trying to, you know, get it.
I was going to surprise him when Elton John was here. No way. The tickets were sold out for more than 3 to 5 years with him coming here.
What do you mean, Grandma?
Elton John.
Yeah. So Elton John?
Yeah.
Reginald.
No way could you buy a ticket.
eBay.
Do you know how much? No way.
Scalpers.
Do you know what those tickets were selling
$500.
For? How about $1,000?
$10,000.
I know East. A ticket broker, but I don't trust them.
Yeah, don't.
I mean, I didn't. I just told somebody about a location. I didn't say go ahead and buy tickets. I just said I knew.
Sigrid wasn't here. I went to see Andre Bocelli.
Who?
I know.
Singer.
You don't even know who he is.
Andre Bocelli.
Yes.
Opera singer.
And when I went on the tour.
Wait. Is it this guy?
Tuscany, Italy. The bus, we were about 25 miles from his home.
Yeah.
They wouldn't go. It wasn't on the tour to go, and they wouldn't go. So when it came time at the hotel to tip the driver and the guy that was in charge of the tour, I didn't give them one dime. They had an envelope. You were there? You're going to let me tell my story?
Let her tell the story.
Giving gratitude.
Let her tell the story, Uncle Siggy.
Right.
They wouldn't go by. They said it's not on the tour to go. Right. They took us down the street, down the road.
This guy.
Down to a road to...
Yeah, but it's a tour, Grandma.
To a, what?
It's a tour. Like, when you go on the tour, it only goes to a few places. It doesn't go everywhere.
But and you think it was just me? The busload was full of people and everybody wanted to go. They were going to pay the driver and the tour guide that was in charge of it to go by Andre Bocelli. I've got a book. When I went, some friends of mine gave me a book on Andre Bocelli's life.
Oh, he's here, still this guy. Living. This guy?
What?
This guy.
I've got tapes of most of them, all of him.
Yeah.
But when he came, I went and bought my ticket.
That guy?
Yeah, it's him.
What is that?
Listen.
That's him.
Yes.
You can look this up on the internet, any song you want.
I know. I'm not...
How about I teach you the internet, Grandma?
Don't talk so loud.
I love you. You want me to teach you the internet?
No.
Why?
Not right now.
You can look up any song you want.
He was on it, and all of a sudden, he stopped going on the internet.
Why'd you stop going on the internet?
Because I listen to music, and I do activities for seniors.
He was in his room, all hooked up. I pay to have that hooked up.
Well, I'll use it.
To going.
Well, I've been doing it anyway.
The internet, you should use the internet every day. It's good. I'm on the internet right now. I live on the internet.
So anyway...
Uncle Siggy was flirting with the internet recently.
So anyway, yeah. Like I said...
Grandma, what's your Instagram?
I've got all kind of tapes on Andre Bocelli.
Grandma, what's your Twitter? People are asking what your Twitter is.
Ask what?
What's your Twitter?
What about it? What is that?
What's your Twitter?
What's a Twitter?
What's your Instagram?
I don't know what
that's my Twitter.
I don't know what
that's my Twitter. That's my Twitter.
You're asking me stuff I don't know.
Oh. So this is my Twitter.
When did you land here?
Like 2 days ago.
Did Josh pick you up?
I was in New York City.
Wow.
Yesterday.
I was in New York. Do you know what I did for New York City?
Do you know anybody there in New York?
A few fans.
Did they meet you at the airport?
They met me in general. They just came to meet me.
Yeah, but where did you stay in New York? I can see.
Can you see that, though?
What did you do in New York?
I streamed in New York City. I've never been to New York City, so I wanted to go stream in New York City. I'm doing this.
Did you go up the Statue of Liberty?
No, we didn't make it there.
Did you go to Times Square?
Yes.
Wasn't that something, huh?
That was awesome. I haven't been to New York.
Laura was going with years ago. Now, this goes way back. She was going with some guy. He was an ex-policeman. And she moved from, this is before Lisa and...
I took that photo.
Who is that?
That's me. On 4th of July in New York City.
You were there the 4th of July? When?
The 4th of July, this year.
This year you were there?
3 days ago.
I saw it live.
Did you?
I watched the program.
It's not the
Did you watch it?
On CBS.
Oh, I was there for the Macy's.
I was trying to look for anybody.
I was there. I was on Pier 6. I was there. I went there.
Really?
I went to go to New York City for...
I watched some of the parade.
That was cool.
It was amazing.
That was cool.
Was it?
That was cool. They had four barges and fireworks. Wow. I was like, whoa.
They showed some.
I was stoned. That was awesome. The weed made it better.
What a stone.
I was smoking weed. The weed
high?
It made it better. It enhances your senses. It makes everything better. It makes food better. It makes TV better.
I'm gonna come here. They haven't voted. They haven't got it.
Marijuana. No, I have a medical card here in Florida.
I know.
I have a medical card.
Justin, it's very expensive.
I'm gonna grow it.
It costs $199.
Yeah, but we can grow some of it legally.
No, I thought it'd be too much money.
No, it's actually...
They have it in the paper ads now if your doctor signs it.
My doctor gave me a card. I'm allowed to grow weed.
They have ads in the paper all the time.
I smoked 5 weeds today, Grandma.
Wow.
I once smoked a whole marijuana.
You mean an ounce?
A whole marijuana, Uncle Siggy.
Well, to me, that's a lot.
What is that? How much is that?
A whole marijuana.
I don't... What is it?
It's a joke.
Oh, a joke?
Oh, I thought you meant, like, you know, that much.
It's a joke. It's a joke. A whole marijuana. I love you guys.
Anyway, I've got to go tomorrow. It's Monday.
Monday.
And take all the papers to the city of Pembroke Pines, and then I'll have to wait six months to a year
for them
to wait in line to get the floor done and the ceiling.
Tell them what you're doing. Tell them everything. Here. So
tell
here,
who
this is my chat.
Oh, I don't want people to know
it's fine. They don't need this. Yeah, but they know everything about us. It's okay.
Who knows about us?
Here, everybody.
Who are these people?
These are my friends. They watch me. I have to go to the bathroom.
They're your friends?
Yeah, just talk to them. Be nice.
Right. I didn't know you had friends.
These are all my friends. They watch me.
Yeah, I don't want to tell them anything.
No, will you tell them anything? They want to know about my family. They watch me, and they pay my bills. Like I'm their entertainment.
I don't believe it. I don't want them to see me.
Look
at me.
You're beautiful.
No.
You're beautiful.
Grandma's old.
Look, they're talking to you right there. That's how they talk to you. They type. Can you read that, or is it too small?
Wait a minute.
I want to show you. This is what I do for a job. This is my job. This is my job. Look. There's a heart. There's some hearts for you. They're saying hello. Eddie says hello. Battle Cam says hi. They're all talking to you.
Hi.
They're all talking. Hi, Grant. See, they love you.
I can't. No, they don't know me. Can they see me?
I tell them about you all the time. These people here, we love your grandma. This is Berwa. He's a friend of mine. I know him in real life.
Do you know how old I am? Don't tell him.
No, here, talk to them. I have to go to the
How doctor. Old am I?
Ask them.
Yes. Harry, who is this? Do you know how old I am? Hello? Yes. I'll tell you if you're right. See the numbers. I don't see numbers. How old am I? You're going too fast. Stop. Nobody's put the age down yet.
It takes a minute.
I'm waiting. Hello? Somebody put 55? You gotta be kidding. 80? No, you're closer, Rob. You're closer. Keep going. No, I'm not 100 yet. Get out of town. No, not 89. Not 79. No. Nobody's guessed it yet. What's the number? I'll tell you if somebody guesses it right. I'll throw you a kiss. The one that guesses my age right now. No, not 86, 90, no. 100, no. No. 18, really? Nobody's guessed my age yet. Don't you tell them. Nobody's guessed.
I'm not going to tell them, Grandma.
No.
Let them guess.
They put 78, 79. No. Nobody's getting 92. Get out of 103. No. 4. Oh, no. Nobody has guessed my age.
That's wild. Not yet?
No.
Not
nobody,
yet?
No. Don't you tell
them. Somebody tell them, Grandma.
No. Don't you tell them. Nobody's guessed it yet. Nope. Stop. Jim. Get him back. He got it.
Jimmy.
Yeah, right.
Too lit. Jimmy too lit.
He guessed
he
it.
He got it. Yeah, Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy, you win.
He won. He guessed it. 87.
Hey, it's awesome.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
It is 87 years old. Yeah. Good for you. Where he's coming back on again.
Yeah, they type. People do. It's just, you know.
Tell him he was right, Jimmy.
He's right. He can hear you.
Oh.
They can. They're right there. But yeah, this is how
87.
I read.
87. You're right. He's the only one so far. Look. So I put 100. Get out of town. I'll be lucky if I get 100.
No, you'll get 100. What do you mean, Grandma?
84. See, nobody else has put it again. I just told them. No, now 86. Close.
They're saying you
one
look.
One more.
Oh, Dimension 7, oh, 87.
Okay, right there.
Dimension 7 has got 82.
What is that, Dimension?
That's his name. That's their screen name.
Somebody has that name?
Yeah, they have different names. Yeah, see, they have all sorts of different screen
87,
names.
87, right.
Yeah. Tell them a story.
What kind of story?
Anything. About anything.
About Justin and
about
Joshua
me,
to
about...
my beautiful grandsons. Yeah. Yes, I took very good care of them.
Did you raise us?
Almost.
Why did
both of you?
Why did my mom and dad live in the ghetto? Why did they live in the hood over in that neighborhood?
They didn't live in the ghetto. They lived in a very nice house. Your mother and
yeah,
father.
Yeah, but why was that? Why was that neighborhood ghetto?
No, you two boys were the first.
We were the first.
And there's Justin, and Joshua, and Bernadette, and she's married in. I think she's living in Gainesville. Brandon and Brian. And I forgot the others. That one that Lisa has. What are
I don't
their
know.
Names? Did you, you know, Sigurd and I took them to, had them for about 4 or 5 hours.
I don't know their names.
When they were here.
I don't know.
Yeah.
We went to Hollywood Beach.
No, we took him to an art museum.
So wait, you would say that area, that my dad's house, you say that's a good area?
Yes, I think it's very nice. Your father had the house.
No, not the house, not his house, his neighborhood.
I don't know the people that his neighbors.
No, I'm not talking about the house. The house is nice.
And I, yeah.
But I'm talking about the area, the neighborhood.
As far as I know, I don't live there.
I live there.
If they ever had any problems, I don't know that.
Do you ever have helicopters flying
they
around?
They never told me.
Do you ever have helicopters flying around your neighborhood looking for people at night?
No.
I did.
Here it's very quiet.
I used to have helicopters flying around my neighborhood at night looking.
I
for
don't
people.
Have. I have yeah. neighbors, but. That's it.
Uncle Sigurd,
if I see him,
wait, would you?
Planes flying around.
No. Helicopters searching my neighborhood
right.
for people. Do you think that's a good neighborhood?
Well, the airport here is too
No, bomb. My house. Jesus
Don't
Christ.
Don't talk so loud.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, but wow. You're talking about California?
My house, my dad's house. My dad's area.
Look, I don't know anything about that. Here, come take this. He's all well wound up, I'm telling you. I don't know why he's so excited. It's good to see him. I do have wonderful grandchildren. I cannot say anything bad about them. What they do, they're all grown ups now, and they make their own decisions. No, I don't make any decision for them whatsoever.
No, a lot.
And I feel very lucky that they're such wonderful children. And I still call them children.
Please meet with Linda.
Huh?
They want you to please meet with Linda.
No way. Jose. That ain't gonna happen.
Why?
I'm not going into personal things because none of you can do anything about it. What's done, and that's
well, they care about you.
Unforgivable.
They care about you. You know that.
Unforgivable. Still, no. No, can't be. No. Shame. And Brent was here banging on the door wanting money. Really? Why didn't they go to...
No, they can't. They hear you from there.
I don't care.
This is just how you...
I don't care. Why didn't they go to the grandfather?
Yeah.
To my ex for money.
Right.
And I'm telling you, right now, if he'd have paid half on Laura's funeral and everything, I would have paid the other half.
Right.
But they didn't do that. They were after me for 100%. And I live on certain money every month. I'm not crying poor mouth to anybody.
Get some drink, Justin.
Sigurd and I are going to, Sigurd lives with me now, and we do the bills half and half. But before, I lived here by myself, many years, all by myself, and I took care of me. I'm number one. And I said, shame on Linda. And one thing, whatever she took of Laura's, she can't take it with her. No way, Jose. That is my satisfaction. And Brent was banging on the front door here wanting his money. Why didn't they go to Keystone Heights and get money from her, from Linda's father? And why didn't Brent go bang on Sigurd's door, his ex, I don't know what he called Sig. They were after me for 100%. I worked at Walmart and I took care of me. I didn't ask anybody to help me out or do any money. I worked there 21 years. Okay.
No. 21 years.
Shame on your mother. Leave that.
I'm moving it over because I want to bring a chair.
Why?
Here.
For doing that, what she did, you weren't in the room. You don't know what was going on in that room. And thank God, Josh.
I was sleeping.
Joshua was there to help me out. Not to tell me what to do, but he was there
for
support.
You,
and one good thing, Michael was there. And whatever Linda said, whatever Linda decided, with Brent's personal card, he went 100% with her. So since the bad things were there in that funeral home, and I had to sign the paper.
Shh, don't talk about sad things. Don't talk about sad things, Grandma. Don't talk about sad things.
Yeah, my daughter cremated. I'm still feel I want my daughter to forgive me. I loved Laura. I said I had to sign those papers to have her cremated. And Linda said, I'm paying for the funeral, Brent's card. And what about the container for the ashes? She's got it at her house. She at Brent's house. And they've got it there. You've seen it, haven't you?
Do you want it?
Have you seen it?
I'll steal it.
No, you're not going to steal it.
I'll steal it.
No. And Linda's got a lot to live with. And I said, shame on her. And I miss Laura, my beautiful daughter.
I'm sorry. Don't cry, Grandma.
No more.
Don't cry. Talk about something happy.
I do feel guilty about it.
You're not guilty at all. You're not guilty at all, Grandma.
For me to sign that bad thing, that funeral director was going to tell me everything they do. If you know anybody that's ever been cremated, then you'll know. I don't want to know. I said, don't tell me. I don't want to hear it.
I'm sorry. Yeah, change it. I want to change the subject. I don't want to talk about sad things, Grandma. I know. You don't have to keep. It's still living in her head. Every day.
I have a picture. I just showed you her. You know, I had
She thinks about my aunt every day, guys. It's nothing personal. It's just still fresh in her mind.
Wait, when you have to do that.
I didn't do it. See, now he's blaming it on me.
No.
Joshua's blaming it on me now.
No.
He said it's my fault.
No. It's not his
fault. Did I make you feel this? I make you talk about this?
No.
You chose to talk about this. I didn't say anything.
You wanted to know about my family.
Yeah. You guys asked her questions. Talk about happy things. Talk about your mom. I want to know about your mom.
My mother, when my father died, he got up and went to work one morning. At 36 years old, he had a massive heart attack.
I don't
want
to talk about negative things. Talk about positive
My mother
things.
Was good. My mother lived till 95 years
you
old.
You don't remember? I want to talk about happy things about your life. I don't want to talk about sad things.
We always had plenty to eat.
I just want to know about your life. Like,
telling you.
I want to know about you as a child. I want to know about your child. I don't want to know about sad things.
You know? Hey.
I don't want to talk about anything sad or negative. That's why I never ask. You feel me?
Thank God Joshua was there.
No, I don't want to talk about sad things. I want to talk about
He
good
was
things.
There for support, and I love him.
Why do you only want to talk about sad things?
I don't.
Why?
Legs tipped $5.
Thank you.
We love you, Grandma. Don't cry. 400 people are watching, and we all love you. Hearts in the chat for Grandma.
They love you. People love you. Don't cry, dude. It's okay. I know it's always on your mind.
It is always.
I know it. Did I bring it up?
Look at that picture over there.
Did I bring
look
it up?
At her.
I know you have pictures everywhere. Did I bring it up? Joshua said that I brought it up.
No, he didn't. Joshua.
I didn't bring it up. He's literally sitting here saying,
"No, Josh. No, Josh. You're wrong. You're wrong. You're wrong, honey."
I asked her to tell me a story. And then that's the story she chose. I didn't choose that story. I want to know about your life. I want to know about happy stuff.
Let's don't
Josh,
do it
you're a horrible
anymore.
Person, Josh.
Just stop. You want a cold drink?
I want you to be happy.
I'm fine.
What can I do to make you happy?
I'm fine.
What can I do to create happiness for you?
Just be a good boy. That's
I am
all.
Being good. I'm here. I'm here
you
for
know,
you, man.
Brandon,
I'm not
Bernadette,
trying to make you sad. I never wanted to bring...
It's all the grand... I want the best for my grandchildren.
Okay, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing very good. I'm doing very well for myself, I think. I think I'm doing well. I have ups and downs.
I shouldn't have gone into all this. I'm sorry. I apologize.
No, you're
everybody.
Fine. It's on your mind. You're a real person. And all you know how to do is, you know... Tell how you feel. You're expressing what you think. That's just what's on your mind. Nobody brought it up.
I miss my mother and my father, you know? Hey, I think about them. You know, when the holidays come around, you think about your grandmother and your grandfather.
I'm here.
And your mother. They're still, no matter what happened, and I always told you and Joshua, whatever happened between your mother and your father, you had nothing to do with it. Nothing. That was between those two. They made their own decision. Not because of you two boys.
I love you.
Did I always tell you that?
I love you, Grandma.
Did I always tell you and Josh?
Give me a hug. I love you.
And that's the truth.
I love you.
Whatever happened between Laura and Alan when she was married, that was between
I don't even remember that.
I know.
I don't even remember
we went up to Laura and Alan's house.
Can we talk about something
positive?
You know,
positive? And had the little cards, you know? When Christmas and here, when I opened the garage door, I had the cards.
Yeah.
Grandma bought those.
Oh. I want to talk about something happy.
It was you and Brandon, Joshua, and I had bought cars from Walmart. For each one in a tricycle, for Bernadette.
Yeah, you always did nice things.
Do you remember doing that?
Yeah, you always did nice things.
You know, I tried to do what I could.
I had a great childhood because of you. I had a very good childhood because of you. You gave me a great childhood, and I am forever grateful.
I tried to do the
No, you didn't. You did. It's not you tried. You did. You did what?
You know,
you did good.
And Sigurd, I'm so grateful that Sigurd's here. Sigurd's here. I don't know why you're sitting back in there, Sigurd.
I'm trying to be heard.
Well, come in here and sit.
And tell what's going on, Mom.
I'm glad he's here.
He
can come and go and do what he wants.
No, Brandon didn't steal any grandpa's
Brandon
money.
Has problems.
Brandon has problems. Brandon was locked up. He's locked up.
Bad.
He got drunk.
I don't know.
He has autism. He has autism, but it's very severe. It's severe. Yes, my cousin has severe autism, and I don't know what else. I know it's a form of autism. I have mild. I'm very mild form. I'm fine. I can function. I can work. I can, you know, do what I have to do to fucking survive. But Brandon, fucking shit.
Well,
he has it way worse.
He doesn't know
how to control himself.
Well,
he.
Michael, thank God, Michael's got him home. And he calls me all the time. Brandon calls me all the time.
I just want him to be good.
Sigurd's talked to him. He calls and he says, Grandma, how you doing? This is Brandon. And he called me a couple of days ago and I called him back.
Yep.
And I'll wait a couple of days. All of a sudden he'll call me. You know, how you doing?
No, my cousin's like way off.
Brian's working. He's
doing good.
Roofing.
Oh, fuck.
Michael
roofing.
Did roofing, but he's doing yard work now in Keystone.
God damn, what's...
Bernadette, again, got married a couple of years ago now when she got married.
Bernadette got married?
Yeah.
Again? Yikes.
No, she'd never been... Bernadette? No, she'd never been married before.
All right.
Instead of the couches.
Beautiful girl. When she came here, I saw her and we went and spent the day together. We had lunch. Very nice, very sweet girl.
Who?
Brandon's a good boy. He's working.
Wait, who? Who? Wait, Bernadette's gay?
Bernadette, her married name, I don't know.
No, wait, is Bernadette gay or is it a man or a woman?
No. Bernadette is a girl.
Oh, I thought she married a man or a woman, I said.
No, she's my granddaughter. And Brian?
I asked you a question. Did Bernadette marry a man or a woman?
Married a man.
Oh, that's what I'm asking.
Oh, no.
Because you made it sound like it was a woman.
Oh, no. She's married to a man.
Okay.
And I asked Brandon. He said she's very happy. She's a RN. She's a nurse in the hospital in Gainesville, Florida. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
She's a nurse, and she went to see when your grandfather was in the hospital. Bernadette worked in that hospital where your mother took your grandfather, and she was a nurse on that floor. And help take care of your grandfather.
Yeah.
You know he's 92 years old.
I know he's 92. He has the Alzheimer's.
I know.
Yes. I saw him the week of Flag Day for Friday. I went up there, not only in Keystone Heights, but we commuted back and forth to Gainesville over a three-day period.
How was that?
Kind of just like a bit rushed. Tried to get enough sleep each day, though. It's really important. And we checked around, and it was real quiet all around.
But some of the time, you said he knew you. He knew who you were.
Of course. Sometimes, yes. Sometimes, no. Sometimes with Michael. Sometimes, yes. Sometimes, no. Sometimes with Josh. He likes to be called certain ways. Sometimes, yes. Sometimes, no. And it was just...
This is family. You wanted to know about family.
Man, I want to start doing this. Seriously.
Is this sad?
How about depression?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, he's really close. He's going to be lucky he even gets out in July 2019.
Holy shit.
Yeah, it's real. It's serious, critical, guarded.
But you stayed at the lake. You stayed yeah. that through it's, the divorce. It's changed our house was his.
Oh, there's boats around, but it's so low, they even have stakes down where the water was at one level.
So the water's low now.
You can walk. You can walk like quarter of a mile.
It's up now? They said the water's up?
Might be.
You could walk nearly a quarter of a mile. It's that low down.
Really?
Oh, yeah, because a couple of years ago, the, what is that? Where, Fort, what's it called? What's the place up there?
The U.S. government.
Wait.
Nijka tipped $2. Grandma tells us about your time working in the service and boot camp.
For $2, they said, tell us about the time you worked in the service and the boot camp.
Who, me?
Yeah, tell them about when you were in the service and your boot camp experience.
Oh, no, I went home and, oh, well.
Tell us about when you were in the service.
When I was in service, I did Fort Lee, Virginia is where I took my basic. Then they sent me home for 30-day leave, and I got my assignment to Washington, D.C. And my assignment, I was going...
Listen.
Listen
to her.
In the Pentagon in Washington, D.C.
She worked in the fucking Pentagon.
Is a dispensary. And that's for only the service people to see a doctor, a dentist, male, female, but I only could go, like, your girlfriends, if you have them, or the girls know what I'm talking about. When you go into a doctor for examination, somebody had to be present. I wanted to be a nurse, so I worked for a captain, lieutenant, doctors, 4 men orderlies, 1 Navy nurse, and me. So one of us had to be in with the doctor for the examination for the female. They wouldn't let us go in for any examination for the males. Those were the rules. That's okay. And you could get everything done there. And I wish you could have seen the party that they had for me when I left. Everybody didn't want me to. I was good. Honorable discharge. Oh, yes, I've got that.
Ew.
Oh, yeah. And one thing, my ex, we rented an apartment off base from Fort Meade is where I was assigned to, and I would drive from, we lived 2 blocks from the White House. We rented an apartment 4 flights up. No elevator, $77 a month. Now you're going back for rent. And we had a bedroom, a bathroom, and a little kitchen. And we rented there 10 years. And we, Sig worked in Jacksonville, Florida for Western Electric. So he got a transfer from Western Electric in Jacksonville, Florida to Washington, D.C. He walked to work. I drove the car over to the base, took the shuttle bus to the Pentagon, and went and worked in the dispensary.
What's a dispensary?
It's
where they had weed?
No. They had minor things. Cuts, burns, boils.
So is that what they called it? It was not an infirmary.
That's what you call it infirmary, they call it dispensary. Just for minor things. No big surgery there.
Oh.
Oh, no. And everybody, I did my job. Absolutely. I was 100%. And sometimes I was there, you know, for different examinations for the females only, but they all had to be in service.
Oh. Hey, Mexican Andy.
Yeah, and we went to the Smithsonian Institute if nobody's been to Washington to see that, you plan on spending a whole week to keep going back because you'll never see everything there.
What years
were
you?
We went in the White House. I was 18 years old.
What years?
So I'm telling you, from when I was 18, I'm just my mother signed for me to join the Army. I should have gone in the Navy or the Air Force, but I didn't because they make you hard, like hard butt. They take no crap off of you. The girls, no cramps, no headaches, no nothing. They would put you on a plane and send you right home. No baby stuff.
You're in the Army?
No, yeah, they didn't care. You marched everywhere. I never got, for my 6 months training, I never got in a car. We marched on the flat tops. Oh. And that's asphalt. Like, streets are made out of.
Holy shit. Yeah.
And you'd go out there, 100 degrees, but you went to class. And you had to, and I went on the rifle range. They taught you had to shoot a gun. Back then, they taught you for the
Nick
gas mask.
$2.
You had to
show
go
Army
in.
Picture and dog tags.
Do you have your picture and dog tags?
Huh? Of course I do.
Where's your picture? It's in this.
No,
room.
The one in there in the bedroom. In my it. Uniform? Yes.
Yep.
I've got some other pictures, but they're in the safe deposit box at the bank. I didn't want, in case my house, or I was afraid to leave too many things, you know, in the house. And this is me, 18-year-old. That's me.
That's my grandma.
I was young once. Hey, when you get 87 years old, let's see.
Fuck it, dude. That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. I could never do that.
Yeah. That's, I got my discharge pipe papers right with my picture.
That's awesome.
We went to see everything in Washington, D.C. It was just like almost like a vacation. And I had Saturday and Sunday off. Would you believe that? In the Army, the dispensary was closed. And so I only worked 5 days a week, always on time. And I never had any problems, never called down, never reprimanded. And I'm not perfect. Just like at Walmart, 21 years I worked at Walmart, never called down, never reprimanded, no problems or anything. So what happened, and it goes with age, sciatic nerve.
The Korean War.
What?
Say Korean War.
What's that mean?
They said that you were in the Korean War.
Yes.
Oh, they love
Show
you.
Show my cap. Oh, Sigurd, on June the 8th, 2019, we went to Washington, D.C., to the Washington Monument. And, yep, I had to wear my hat. I got a shirt. Where's my shirt, Sigurd? They would not let you go to Washington on the tour.
Should I go to Korea?
It's only get to go, no.
I go to Korea or no?
I never went to Korea.
But should I go to Korea?
This is a Korean War.
But should I go to Korea? Is it safe?
I don't know. How do I know?
Do you think they'll kidnap me?
No, and I got a shirt, my hat. And I got a bag. Sigurd's got a hat, a shirt. It's a guardian. When you go on.
She's not a Jew. She's a Catholic.
So what is?
They were asking if you were Jew. No, they want. They're curious.
Let's don't get into.
No, they want to because there's a lot of Catholics here and a lot of Christian.
Okay.
A lot of Christians home.
I don't get in religion. Whatever you are,
believe Jesus.
Oh,
is the Savior.
Get his shirt. On her flight, this is Sigurd's
Jesus
shirt.
Is my Lord and Savior.
On her flight, he was my guardian.
I am.
Get my shirt, Sigurd.
I did not serve. My grandma served.
I wore my hat, my shirt, and they give you a bag. But you only can go one time in your whole life. No matter how long you were in service, no matter what war it was. And it's something that I will always remember. And everything was taken care of. We didn't have to worry about the flight. And Joshua and Justin's father, David, came and picked up Sigurd and I here at the house. He drove us to the airport. At 1 o'clock in the morning, we had to be there. And they had coffee and donuts and orange juice and all that at the airport.
Right.
The plane left about 3 o'clock the same morning. And in 2.5 hours, approximately, we were in Washington, D.C. The bus, a big super air-conditioned bus, was there, and they still had coffee and donuts there. And then...
Thank you for your service, Grandma.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. And Sigurd, you get my shirt?
Mom.
It's right here. You showed it.
That's yours. You have a blue. I have a red.
Okay, where's your red shirt?
I was looking for it.
It's under there. It's on the chair. And everything was timed to the very second. We didn't even have to think of where we were going. We go to Washington, to the Lincoln. We went to all the monuments. And then they took us back for the last monument. They took all group pictures, of the veterans and the guardians. And I'm waiting to get a picture, my picture with Sigurd. And they took pictures of only the veterans. Then they took a picture of only the guardians. And they took pictures of us together. And the flight left Washington, D.C. about, 6:30. And we were back here in Fort Lauderdale Airport. That's, again, it's June the 8th, 2019. And David came and picked up Sigurd and I. Joshua and Justin's father picked us up at the airport. And your shirt isn't there?
No, that's the one from Veterans Day, Mom. And I looked in the rack, and it's not there.
And
it's somewhere else.
Then we, David brought us home. But that's something that I'm glad I did it now. I've still got my mind, my eyes, my whatever. And I want to keep it. For my age, people can't believe that I can still see and understand.
Hi from the UK, Grandma.
What?
Someone just sent me a message. They said, hello from the UK, Grandma.
You really?
Yes. Yes, I have viewers in the UK. I have viewers all over the world.
Oh.
Thank you for your service. Someone else texted me. Just turned on, bro. Your grandma is awesome. Thank you for your service. They love you. My viewers love you, Grandma.
I was good. That was good. I never had any problem. Grandma, not perfect. No. I make a lot of mistakes.
Tell her the gorilla joke.
What, honey?
Do you want to hear a joke?
Yes, I want to hear a joke.
All right, my friend Bjorn, he wrote the joke. So what you do is you have to take EBZ, a black man, and you take a gorilla, right? And you put them... Wait, how do you say it? You put them in a dark room, right? And you turn off the lights, and you put their hands in a box, a dark box, right? And then you open the lid of the box, and then you shine a light on their hands, and you try to figure out which hand belongs to the gorilla and which hand belongs to EBZ.
Because black people have white hands if they have them up, palm up.
Oh.
I know that. So what? Yes.
So
I don't
what?
Get into that. That is not my thing.
Yeah, she doesn't care.
I worked many, many years.
Care. Yeah, well, he's from Denmark, so he doesn't understand. He's from Denmark.
I don't care what color you are, what religion you are. You know, that's not important to me. You know, if you're my friend, and I do have friends, if I probably said I don't. What I mean, like at Walmart, you know, people would, when I first started there 21 years ago, people, a girl told me, now I'm going to tell you this story, and it's true. The girl, I started at Walmart 21 years ago. They hired me in the infants department. And the girl that was training me, she was 21 years old. She was black. She was born in Africa, and she wanted to go back home.
Why?
In her opinion, she didn't like the United States. She didn't like white people.
Oh.
She said, don't take it personal. She says, I'm training you for the infants department here at Walmart. And that's, and she said, I'm leaving in 2 weeks to go back home to Africa where she was born, and that's where her family was. She was on some way, somehow, she got here in the United States, and she got here to Florida. This is her story. And she said, I'm going to tell you a few things, and you can take it for what it's worth. She said, you see nothing, you hear nothing, you know nothing. And I'd never done retail before, so I said, what are you talking about? She said, oh, you'll find out. She said, you'll find out. And she said, you don't loan money and you don't give rides. I said, what kind of a place? She said, you'll find out. So she said, I'm going on my break. You used to get a 15-minute break in the morning, 15-minute break at night. So she said, I'm going on my break. I said, okay. So I was straightening things in the infants department, how people open little socks and shirts and stuff. Women can tell you a lot about that. I said, okay, Africa. And so I was doing my job, straightening things. And here comes the manager. And he said, where is Africa? I said, I have no idea. He said, what do you mean? I said, I'm telling you, I'm doing my job. This is my first night here to start work, and Walmart was only open from 7 in the morning till 8 at night. So getting back to the manager, I said, you have a radio. You can go over in any of the departments and use a phone and call her. But I don't know where she went, because she could have gone to the restroom, snack bar. She could have gone out and met somebody. She could have gone for a smoke. I said, I don't know. And before I knew it, I heard him calling Africa over the intercom at Walmart. You go to stores and you hear him calling people. So I kept doing my job.
Wait, was that her name?
Huh?
Was that her name, or is that what you, they just
her name her? Was Africa, absolutely, yeah.
Like, that was literally her name.
That was her name. And so she came back, you know, and she said, did John come and ask you where I was? I said, yes. I said, I told you, Africa, I don't know where you went. So she said, smart girl. So I've been there maybe, so that was one incident. The next one, before I knew it, and people knew that I was new, and they would come and they'd say, if you got a dollar, you want to get a drink, I don't have any money, or a quarter, want to make a phone call, and we were not allowed to have money on us. We had lockers, and that's where you're supposed to keep your wallet and all your papers and everything. And I had a key, have a lock to it. And I said, no, I don't have any money. And before I knew it, here comes somebody else. Oh, where do you live? And it popped in my head. I said, where do you live? They said, I need a ride. I'm having car problems. And I said, where do you live? They said, oh, I live South Fort Lauderdale. I said, no. I live east toward the beach. I said, no, that's too far. I said, I'm just starting work, and I only have enough money to put gas in my car and keep it up. And I said, no, no, I can't give any rides. And I don't have the insurance that I can give anybody a ride in my car. It only covers me. Smart girl, huh?
Yeah, no, 200 IQ, Grandma.
Yeah,
200 IQ.
So anyway, I thought all this was popping in before I knew it. And Africa, you know, she came. She was going on a plane. She was going, I don't know how she was flying from Fort Lauderdale, from Miami to Africa. So she says it'll take a couple of days and she'll have to transfer. But I never heard from her again. Never heard. I said, send me a postcard. Let me know how you're doing, your family. You know, are you happy there? Do they have a Walmart in Africa?
No. Yeah,
where you can transfer and maybe work there. You know, and you'll be with people of your own race.
Yeah.
You know, I said, you don't like white people. And I said, that's your priority. But I said, I don't get in anybody's color, religious, or where you live, or what you do. That's none of my business. Mm-hmm. You nice to me, I'll be nice to you. That's it. That's the story of Walmart.
That's wild.
Huh? That was true.
Yeah.
Very true.
That's your first name?
Yep. And she signed Africa. That was her name.
That's wild. And you just worked there for 20 years? 21 years.
Yep.
Yeah.
You just dealt with those people.
Oh. She just didn't like white people, and they were not nice to her, and she just wanted to go back where she felt comfortable. That's it. Probably many of you, you know, that's your priority. And I don't care who you are, what color you are, or what you do. That's your own personal
thing. Yeah, Grandma was very progressive.
Hmm?
They said that you were very progressive.
Am I?
Yeah.
I'm telling them the truth.
Yeah. No, they like your story.
They
want to hear your stories.
Yeah, that's a truth.
They want to hear all your stories.
Yeah, no.
They want to know they want to know about my family, where my family came from. They want to know everything about me. They watch me every day.
All right. My father was Irish and he was Catholic. My mother was English and she was Episcopalian. So when my ex and I got married, I had to sign. We were married by a priest in Jacksonville, Florida. And I had to sign the papers that any children that he and I had, they had to be baptized and raised Catholic.
Mm.
And one of my best girlfriends signed that if something happened, that she would take care of the four children, okay?
Yeah.
Not like a guardian.
Yeah.
So I signed the papers, the priest married.
Have something to drink? Have something to drink, they said.
What?
They said to have something to drink. You've been talking for a while. Have a drink.
Okay.
Have a drink.
So then we had so many problems between my mother. She wanted him to change his religion, and his mother was battling that only, you know, that was the only church and that was the only Catholic, had to be. So I went in the service, not to get away from them. I wanted to go and see the world.
Yeah.
When I was 18.
That's what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to see everything.
And I loved history. I made 100%. And I graduated from high school. But I loved history because I said, when I get old enough, I'm going to get a job and make my own money. And I'm going to travel, go where I want to go.
Fuck it.
And, hey, I went through Walmart. I ate a lot of dollar dinners. I'll tell you. And I saved my money to go on trips. Yep. Went to London, Paris, Germany, Scotland, Ireland, and I went in the Vatican. That is awesome. If you've never been are will able to go someday, when you see pictures and everything, but actually walk in that Vatican, it's just awesome. It's just, it was beautiful. And I went to Holland, and oh my gosh, it was in the month of May, and the fields of tulips, you would not believe. And the windmills, really windmills going. And the different color, you see the tulips in a florist or in some stores, but actually you see fields and fields of beautiful different colored tulips. That's what impressed me. And the windmills actually were pumping, was actually grinding, was working.
Oh, yeah, that's what they call it. They call it grinding.
Yes, that's what they were doing. You know, they did corn. I guess they did corn and whatever they grew in those fields. But beautiful. Talking about, I went to all these countries and never saw gum on the ground, dirt, saw paper or anything.
So it was like in Japan.
I know. No, I didn't go to Japan.
No, I went
to,
when I was in Japan. Those
countries. Oh, and the bus tour that I took, the gentleman that got on, I paid for everything here, paid before I went on the trip, and everything was paid for. I didn't have to worry about the bus schedule,
tulips,
or the hotel, or it was on a tour.
Tulips.
Yeah, everything.
Sean White is King tipped $2. What are grandma's thoughts on Trump? Is she concerned socialism and degenerate leftism will destroy the United States?
Really?
They asked you a question.
Oh.
What are your thoughts on Trump? And do you think socialism is going to destroy the United States?
If Trump would keep his mouth shut and just, you know, be president, then I did not vote for him. I'm being honest. You know, if he would just leave things alone. Why is he causing problems here?
What type of problems?
That don't even exist, you know?
Well, he's keeping the illegals out. That's positive.
That's your opinion.
Well, they come here and they take and they don't give.
What have they got to give? Those people don't know anything else. Look what they've lived under. Communists, it's all communists.
In Mexico?
People, they don't know any different.
Wait, Mexico's communist?
All right, what is it then?
I don't know.
They are ruled. Everything. Would you like to live over there? It would be horrible. Here, everything is free. They come to the United States and the streets are paved in gold, so say, which isn't. But, you know, they don't know any better.
They steal your mangoes. They were stealing your mangoes.
I don't know who was stealing my mangoes.
Okay. This is not their country. This is our country.
I know it is.
You can't go. I'm not going to their country and taking from them. I actually take money when I go to
their
country.
Let's never talk.
Let me get something. I don't know how people are going to take it. It's not really offensive, but someone's politically motivated. Have a seat there. Let me show you something.
How do you feel, Uncle Sigurd, about...
Yeah, I'm going to.
I want to hear Uncle Sigurd's take on President Trump.
No, I'm not going to... I'm a man of few words.
Man of few words. He's a man of few words.
Yep, let me get it. I've had this for a while.
What is it? Is it your... where's your MAGA hat?
It's somewhere.
Can I use it?
The MAGA hat is away from my shirt. So, my mother's one-sided. What can I do about it?
What about Yang Gang? Andrew Yang.
No.
No, wait. Have you heard of Andrew Yang?
No.
He's going to give everybody in the United States... $1,000 a month, no matter
what. You mean he's the richest man in the United States?
So here's what he's gonna do. He's gonna get rid of Social Security.
He's going to get rid of food stamps.
Right.
He's going to get rid of all of these government benefits.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he's just going to give you $1,000 every month.
Yeah, but what is he, an entrepreneur? What is
no, he wants to be president.
Oh, you mean so he's instead, going to be getting on the ticket.
So instead of...
What's his name again?
Yang.
Just one word?
Andrew Yang. So
I think I remember.
Let me ask you something. Yes. Instead of you getting your Social Security,
yeah,
right? Would you rather get $1,000 a month?
Well,
Social Security or $1,000 a month?
I have to be an outsider on this because
you're on a fixed income.
Yeah, I'm on a fixed income, but I'm getting pretty old.
Do you think this $1,000? No, you get $1,000 no matter what. No matter what, you just get $1,000. You get $1,000, she gets $1,000, I get $1,000. Wow, everybody.
It's a loaded question. To me, it's loaded. I would have to tell you, like, off camera and off the...
They want to know. They asked your opinion. They want to know your opinion because your opinion matters.
I'm in somewhat of a secure situation.
Ooh.
I'm an exception to the rule.
Some people will be getting more than $1,000.
Oh, well, that means something.
$1,000 pays rent for some people.
You may want to turn that light on because you're going to need it.
Oh, no, it's fine. I have great lighting.
No, I mean, you need to see this.
Show me.
Yep.
Yeah.
Careful, Mom.
Yeah, he can tell you about the town of David where he worked.
Mom, this is getting politics.
Yeah, they like politics.
Getting into politics. Now you see why you need to
have... Thank you for subscribing. My viewers love Donald Trump. They love Donald Trump.
Yeah, but you need to have a light on.
Look.
For somebody to see this. Well, I need the light, Mom. These people are...
I didn't turn the light.
They don't know what's going on. Wait till they see this. This is in
2016. What does that say?
See that? The wall is just what our degraded nation needs. It's an opinion. But look at the shirt really close, folks. See what it says? Somebody took it from the past and did something with Trump. Let me get in there. Hold on.
Is that you?
No. Spectator. Are they doing something about it? Can they see it? The shirt? Can they see it?
Yes. They can see it.
And what's their opinions?
Let me see what it says.
Turn around. Look what somebody did.
Build a wall. Oh, that's you, Uncle Sigurd.
No,
it
is
a cover.
No, that's not me.
Oh, it looks like you.
Spectator. Yep. Somebody says. See what it says? That's only from 2016. This has been ongoing since 2016.
Are they taking your job? Did they take your job, Uncle Sigurd? Did they take your job?
No, I got security.
Oh.
I got security.
Nice.
But who knows what could happen, though?
Yeah, who knows?
In the near future.
Who knows?
I don't know what's going to happen.
Time traveling.
But you see what that heading says?
He's a time traveler.
That's somebody's opinion.
The wall is just what our... Is that your opinion?
No, his opinion right there.
Yeah, but I'm asking you, what's your opinion?
No, I saved it because this is what happened. You see what that... See what that's showing?
Yes.
Look at this.
Confirmed.
Here's the originator of it. Hold on. Rosie the Riveter.
This is
from the 1940s. It's the same thing. It's
Justin underscore pedo underscore loser tipped $2.
Thank you.
Hey, Granny, how do you feel that Justin set a donation goal to fix your roof and the con artist internet beggar lied and conned all his viewers? Why does Justin scam and con his family and the pedophile? Has he always liked kids and touched the mess JCs?
Here we go.
Stack of books.
They're mad at me because my girlfriend...
What happened?
My girlfriend's 19. How do you feel about that?
Not even 21. I know.
So what?
She's pretty young.
Why do you care that? Who cares?
Yeah, I know. Why do they care that my girlfriend's 19? You want to see a photo of her?
Yes.
You want to see my girlfriend?
Sure.
When I got married, I was 18, and your grandfather was 25. Yep. So what?
He's 5 years different.
That's my girlfriend.
Okay.
That's her little sister.
Okay.
I bought her that dress.
Beautiful.
Isn't that a nice dress?
Very nice.
Yeah.
She's very pretty.
Very pretty.
Right? Is she pretty?
Yeah, very.
I bet you people get mad just because I'm showing pretty things.
She lives in California, but she might be coming to Florida.
Oh, okay. All right.
She might be.
You know, I didn't steal this from the library. It has all things. It was discontinued. Discarded. They were going to throw this away. I got this on a raffle or a game of
That's
chance.
My girlfriend.
Okay. Very nice.
Very pretty.
Very.
No.
Hey, if you're happy and she's happy.
I'm happy.
Hey.
Yeah.
Very pretty.
Does she live home?
She lives on her own, but she might be moving here.
Okay. Hey.
She might be moving
here. If she's old enough to live on her own and take care of herself, then hey. So what? What's age got to do with it? Hey, you'd be surprised how many people look at my age. They don't believe that I'm 87 years old.
Yeah.
I mean, we're all different. I know plenty of people, maybe your grandparents are younger, even younger than I am, and they have medical problems.
See?
Not everybody's the built the same way.
Yeah, that's who's on the front.
I know.
Well, that's where the Trump
it's
idea
Photoshop.
Photoshop.
Right? Photoshop.
Justin _does _ drugs tipped $2. Justin is a rapist, pedo. 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 Justin is a rapist, pedo.
Justin is a rapist, pedo.
Justin is a rapist, pedo. Justin is a rapist, pedo. Justin is a rapist, pedo. Justin is a rapist, pedo.
She got her degree. She graduated. Hey.
She graduated high school.
Of course. That's very important. That's what I asked my grandchildren.
She's going to go to college.
Get your diploma.
Nothing wrong
with
that.
You don't have to be college.
Work
hard.
Just
get your diploma because later in life, it's going to pay off.
My grandma does not care. She's 19. My grandma, that's pretty good. Right? It's better that I have a young girlfriend than an old girlfriend.
Why? What's the difference?
Hey, well, there is no difference.
Okay. Are they ready for this? See, in a way, I'm an outsider, but I'm showing some poignant things here.
Yeah.
It's pretty important. Wait till you see this. What does this look like? Is this familiar? Again, in a stack of magazines, as opposed to a stack of books. Notice something?
Yes.
And you've got to read the article.
I know. People do it all the time, Uncle Sigurd.
No, but...
It's common. The people do that because it's just they use references.
Right.
To make a point.
Right. But don't you see, it's Rosie Weaver again, modernized.
Yes, Uncle Sigurd.
Now see?
They're going to do that a million more times.
Oh, man. I saw that. I flipped. I went, oh, my gosh. I got to read the article.
Oh.
Yeah. Everything's there.
What?
Just talking.
No.
Justin, even though this... In the earlier picture from the 40s, she has a pin. Notice how they got her done.
Yes.
Ah. I know. I'm just trying to make a poignant thing. That's all. Now, here's the kicker.
Uncle Sigurd has a nuclear bunker.
Yeah. I
confirmed.
But see, they didn't even see this. If they saw this, they'd really be wigging out.
And what are they saying?
They're saying all sorts of stuff.
Okay. Yeah.
Should I show this or probably not? What do you think? Should I show him that?
Yes.
Okay.
Go for it. Just show him.
Okay. Prep him up.
No, just show him. Just show him.
Okay.
Just show him. They'll see it. Yeah. They can see it. I'm looking at it right now. Go, Siggy.
People are like, whoa, what's going on here?
My grandma was 18. And my grandpa was 28, and they got married. Mind you, it was different times back then. But they're still together for 60-plus years.
Yeah.
Nice. I like Lauren. Lauren, I don't have a problem with Lauren.
Sorry about it.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you need an espresso or something, or some kind of energy drink.
Let me see, what about those pictures? Show me pictures. What do you say?
Of her?
What? Who
is that? That's not pictures. That's us, live.
Oh.
Wow.
This is just YouTube.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, the light's okay.
You know one thing that I regret, though?
What do you regret?
Where we lived in Jacksonville, Florida.
Yeah.
My mother,
yeah,
like I say, lived in three different houses, but the last house, you know, that she lived, she worked for HRS for 33 years.
No shit.
Yeah. Yeah. And she retired at...
Justin_touches_granny_tipped$2. Hey, Granny Justin wants to touch you in weird places. He also has incest fantasies.
That was gross.
Yeah, that
Thank you for a $2 donation there. I appreciate you.
Yeah, that's uncalled for.
Thank you for a $2 donation.
I don't like
that. They're giving you... Who is this guy?
They sent $2 to say crazy shit.
What does that mean?
He said crazy shit.
I don't know what that means.
So for $2...
All right.
He can send me a message to say whatever the fuck he wants.
Really?
Yes. This is my job.
They're sending you money?
Yes! This is my job.
This is your job.
This is what I was doing last time. This is what I did before.
Yeah.
Yes.
But what I wish, my mother lived 95 years again, and I wish I'd have made tapes of things that she saw in her lifetime.
Yeah.
You know, she was born in Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Where's that?
That's in Alabama.
Your mom's from Alabama?
I never went there.
You've never been to Alabama?
That's where my mother was born.
I heard there's a lot of racists in Alabama. Is that true?
Huh?
Is it true there's racists in Alabama?
I don't know. How do I know? I've never been to Alabama where she was born. They moved to Jacksonville, Florida.
Roll
Tide. Her father worked for the railroad company. He was a switchman. And I can remember when my grandmother would drive. He only worked at night. And we're going back many, many, many years.
Alabama.
No. In Jacksonville, Florida, he was a switchman.
In Alabama?
I don't know about Alabama.
No.
Where they work. And he was a switchman for the railroad in Jacksonville, Florida. Back then, they had the switchman that would have a light. And they had a lighthouse near the railroad station. And he would go get out of the building that he was in and turn the trains would come and he would do the switching of the railroads.
Drink water, Grandma. You got to drink. You got to drink a lot of water.
Yeah. So what's been their opinion when they saw
I used to go
things?
Ride with my grandmother to take my grandfather from Ortega, which is a little town, and she would drive him to the switch tower of where he would, at night, the trains would run, and he would get out of the tower with the light and
drink more water.
Switch the train tracks.
Yeah.
Then, wasn't that something? I believe it was that the Atlantic Seaboard is
Grandma
what it was
lean.
Called.
Grandma needs promethazine. They said promethazine coating for Grandma.
What?
It's vodka low-key. Grandma drinks the vodka low-key.
Yeah.
Would you ever smoke weed?
No. No.
Kick-ass JC tipped $2. Grandma, Justin took money from us to fix your roof, then he kept the money.
Oh my God.
What did they say?
They said, when I gave you the money, remember when I gave you money when I was here last time?
What?
Do you remember when I gave you money from last time? You don't remember, we were sitting here and I gave you money.
I don't remember.
Jesus Christ. Do you remember that we went to...
I'm not after your
money. Remember we went to Golden Corral after?
Yeah.
You remember we went to... Yeah. You remember we went to Golden Corral.
Yeah, I know.
She doesn't remember we went to Golden Corral.
Every once in a while we go there.
She doesn't remember we went to Golden Corral that day. When I was here last time, we went to go out
there to eat.
Or was it Piccadilly?
That's a pretty good choice.
We went to one of those places.
That's near Presidential Circle.
She doesn't remember. She drove there.
You know what it had? It's a goldfish.
That's Piccadilly.
You don't remember we went there to eat?
Piccadilly,
yes. We went to eat.
You said the Golden Corral.
That's the same thing.
No, it's not.
What's the difference?
We went to Piccadilly. I remember that.
What's the difference?
Buffet. It's both of them are buffets.
I'm telling you, it was the Piccadilly. Yes, I do remember that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cheeseburger tipped $2 to fix the roof.
7 triple 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 7 triple
Do you need money?
You know, but you're not, it's not the roof on the house, it's the floor and in the master bedroom ceiling.
Oh, yeah.
You think I'm at, I've got my own money. I don't want anybody, any charity. I don't need it. I get Social Security.
So what have been people been saying about
they
me?
They think I'm poor?
They love you, Uncle Siggy.
Yeah, but what have they been saying? Anything on the positive side?
Yes.
I'm getting political?
I'm sure they got grandparents or parents love Donald that Trump. Need money. Give it to them.
They love Donald Trump.
I don't know, man.
They love Donald Trump on the scene.
I don't know, man. I don't know if I'm...
What is your opinion?
Of what? Donald Trump?
Yeah. Isn't that what you just said?
I like Donald Trump. I think he's doing an okay job.
Okay. That's your opinion.
He's doing okay.
Okay.
All right. The market's up. If the stock market looks like this, if the stock market looks like that all the time, because of him.
See what Walmart stock is, then, if you can bring it up. I want to see what...
Walmart is down 3 cents. 34 cents.
Wow.
Walmart is 111. It's up, actually. Walmart's actually up.
I worked for another company here in Florida before Walmart. 17 years. It was called...
This is where Walmart was. Walmart was once, in 2009, Walmart was about $40 to $50 a share. It's doubled since then.
I bought shares at Walmart. I bought 401k and I had to split it. That's personal.
Fine.
Walmart's up. But it's down today. It's up, though. For the past 10 years,
it's been going up. Amphenol. Amphenol. I worked for that company 17 years before Walmart.
A-N-P-H?
A-M.
A-M.
P-H-E-N-O-L. Amphenol.
Wow.
They moved to Durham, North Carolina. I don't know if it's...
A-M-P-H...
E-N-O-L, Amphenol. It's an electric company.
Amphenol Corporation?
Yes. Are they in Durham, North Carolina?
Yeah, they're up. They're up really high because of Donald Trump.
I bought a little stock, and I'd still get a check from Amphenol. Every month.
Don't sell Amphenol.
Amphenol?
Before you read this.
The electric company.
Before you read this...
I'm not going to sell it. I'm going
to
keep it.
The goal of this article is to teach you how to use this price-to-earn ratio.
Are they still considered electric company?
Yeah, they're huge.
They make companies.
We underscore love underscore you tip $2. Justin using you for content, you old fucking granny kick Justin out. He is using you for donos, stupid old biatch. Fuck you, granny kick Justin's. As for using you, pick those saggy tits up and kick him out, Justin.
I don't see
Can't
that.
You talk without using those nasty words? My God, what's wrong with this person?
I don't know, but thank you for $2. He said, I'm using you for content, but people want to see my family. I want.
They like to hear all them those words?
No, they're just filthy.
Hey, I'm no virgin or anything. I've used some of them myself, but not where everybody else can hear it.
Ignorant.
You can't just plain talk.
Uneducated.
I don't care. People. No.
Uneducated, ignorant. I mean, it happens, dude. It happens. Some people say wild shit from time to time. Whoa! They're laughing that you called that person out.
Shame, shame. Well, I mean, I go out, I date. Do you think I would let any man use filthy, dirty, nasty words around me? I do not tolerate that. No way.
Grandma keeps it classy.
I don't care. You open that door, you be a gentleman. If you want to take me out, you come dressed to take me out to a nice place. I'm not after your money. I got my own money if I want to go to the Ritz to eat. Uh-uh. If you want my company, you talk nice.
Yeah, you got to be nice to my grandma.
You better believe it.
And push the chair as needed, remember? Pull it out and then you push it in?
Yeah.
I don't know what else. Maybe you can tip the hat.
I don't want nothing. At my age, they're older men. Most of them are divorced or their wives have died. I don't want to hear any crybaby, what your wife did, what she cheated on. No. My evening is not going to be like a counselor listening to what your wife did. How she died, when she died, I don't care. My presence with you for evening is I want to be nice and pleasant.
Kick ass JC tipped $2. Grandma, you are one hot gilf. We know Justin is not your fault. I'm sorry you have to put up with him. He's broke and homeless, by the way. That's why he's back in Florida.
Look, he's my grandson. Whatever he does, he's a grown man. I do
Dragon
not
Ball tipped $2. Granny, I buy a lot of connectors from Amphenol. I spend millions a year for metro stations.
What are they saying about Amphenol?
In D.C.
I worked for that company 17 years and I was good. I was a good worker. Always on time. Punctuality to me was, well, I guess that really taught me to be on time, and that's what I tried to teach my grandchildren. Be on time.
I'm on time. I'm always on time.
Hey, you got a phone, you got a, you can call, and at least you got a job. You can't be courteous enough to call.
Yep.
Call somebody, anybody in the company. They have recordings now.
Change underscore grannies underscore diaper tipped $2. Fook, you can't shut up, old biatch. Get fooked in the ass, fook you biatch. You old biatch, change your diaper. When will you go?
Be nice. Thank you for $2, dude. Yeah, they're being mean.
Knowledge is power. Ignorance is bliss. Bliss.
Bliss?
Bliss.
Bliss.
Blister.
Hey, just think of these guys that are out with their girlfriends or, you know, I don't want to hear dirty jokes. Where is he going?
I have to go to his brother.
He'll be back. I'll wait.
See what, you know, that's really uncalled for.
I don't
drawing
care.
Drawing unnecessary attention to
I don't
yourself.
Appreciate dirty, filthy language.
Well, you see my reaction. It's just like, wow.
I might think it, but I'm not going to, you know, embarrass myself.
Yeah, here he is.
To use them, especially when everybody else is listening.
Yeah.
You know.
Hi. Wait. I want you to say hi right quick. Just say hi right...
What?
Hi. I was with my grandma. I got you.
Who is this?
It's my girlfriend, but she's in the bathroom.
Hi, girlfriend.
Her name is Lauren.
Hi, Lori.
Lauren. Her name is Lauren.
I said Lori.
Lauren.
Lauren. Okay.
Lauren.
All right, Lauren. That's my southern accent.
She's a southern girl. She's from South Carolina.
Okay, Lauren.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, that's my opinion. I'm going to tell you what I think. I'm not 100% right. Like I say, I made a lot of mistakes, and I'm still going to make them. I'm not
that's
perfect.
Everybody.
There's no such person, and just I'm using this. There was only one perfect person. Okay, one perfect person, and look what happened. And we're all suffering from it.
It's true.
That's it. If you can't figure that out, something's wrong with you.
Yep, that only means we're human.
I like this girl. She has great values.
Okay.
Grandma.
That's good.
She has really good values. Well, good. Finish going potty and call me back. All right, love you. Yeah, that's Lauren.
All right, I hear you.
Well, what? What's her name? What? She's going potty.
All right, what do you want to show him?
No, this is the kicker. I'm looking at it. You're looking at it. Somebody made that. My mother needs to see it. I know, check that out. What do you think that's really saying?
It says, build the wall, Uncle Sigurd.
No, but don't you see this thing?
Is that a wall?
No, it's...
Is that what the wall should look like, Uncle Sigurd?
No, it's distress. Don't
Justin
you see the
underscore
fire
is
down?
Underscore pedo tipped $2. Fook you, grandma cunt bitch ass old fook. Fook you, grandma cunt bitch ass old
don't
fook.
Listen to
fook you, grandma cunt
negative,
bitch ass
negative
ass
comments.
Is this person talking really a man?
Yeah.
It's How can you tell if it's a man or a woman?
It's probably a man. They keep giving me $2 though, so whatever.
Thanks. I appreciate it, but you know what? I found this.
You found it?
I found it. It's messed up. You know?
Grandma, does it make me a pedophile if my girlfriend's 19?
No.
My girlfriend is 19 years old. She's an adult. Does that make me a pedophile?
You keep asking me this.
But that's what they're asking.
No, I don't know the girl. Whatever she is.
She is 19. Does that make me a pedophile?
No. In my opinion, no.
Your opinion means
more
than most people.
I was
15,
16 years old when I was dating.
Oh.
Dating.
Okay.
I used to go to the University of Florida. Used to go to all the football games and the rallies.
Yeah.
Florida Gator.
I saw in person, going back, Harry James. Tommy Dorsey.
Yeah,
nice. Jimmy Dorsey.
Oh, really?
Those were the on the stage in the big gym that they had in Gainesville.
Yeah.
Hey, I was 15, 16 years old dating college men.
Ayo.
Oh, yes.
Ayo.
I wanted a guy that was mature. Some of them were, you know, not perfect. But I went out on dates and I had good times and I went to the football Gator Growl. I was a Gator Growl girl.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Tip $2. Granny, I will turn you cripple butthole into my cum bucket. I would face F the life.
Yeah, they're saying crazy shit.
No, this is one person's.
The Gators aren't doing too good this year.
Unnecessarily foul attention or obscene attention to themselves.
I mean,
they're trying to get, you know, people drawn in. He's baiting them.
Who?
This person. Other people can hear this, right?
Yeah.
If you go back in the history of the Gators.
He's baiting people to say negative things.
He was under Papa John. I don't know his real name. Yeah.
Gator skin.
Gator gal.
Gator, gator.
That was a gator gal.
Gator, gator.
But I went to the football games, and back then, you had to wear, main thing for women, we wore suits. The guys wore coats and suits. They wore suits and ties to football games.
Right.
See, the years have changed now. I mean, even going out to dinner. You don't have to come in a coat and tie to take me out.
No.
But it depends on where you're taking me.
Here.
I want you to come dressed.
Read what they're saying.
I want you to be dressed nicely.
Yeah, they like hearing your opinion.
You know, the whirlpool.
You want me to be dressed nice for you?
Caught in it.
If we go on a picnic, jeans, shorts, shirt. But if we go out to a dinner to a nice restaurant, I want you to come. You don't have to wear a coat and tie. Just wear a sports jacket. And you want me to be dressed nice?
Gay_AF $2. Justin rapes kids. Fuck you, stupid old bitch. Justin is a loser. Justin rapes kids.
My girlfriend is 19. She's not a kid.
She's probably more mature. I was very mature for my age.
Lauren's very mature.
16, 17, 18 years old. When I dated, a lot of guys didn't know how old I was. What's the age got to do with it?
Yeah, what does age have to do with it? Why? I don't understand.
I don't understand it either. Why that's so important.
I don't know.
Some women, are just out after a guy for money. I wasn't out for a guy to go on a date. I worked in a store in Jacksonville, Florida, and I went to school. When my father dropped dead at 36 years old, in Jacksonville, my mother worked for the telephone company. We didn't even have a car. She used to ride the bus in downtown Jacksonville. We lived in Ortega, a little town. She'd ride the bus to go to the telephone company, and she was an operator.
Take a break.
No problem.
Miss Starkers.
She's reading the readouts.
Hey, tipped $2. Justin is a thief and a rapist. Granny, look out, he will fuck you too. Justin is a thief and a rapist. Granny, look out, he will fuck you too. Justin is a thief and a rapist. Granny, look out, he will fuck you.
This guy has some mental illness going on.
He has mental illness?
Yeah, that thing that you didn't hear because you were in the restroom?
Yeah.
Bad.
What did he say?
Like rated X. It was bad, okay? If you can...
Yeah, he's mad because my girlfriend is 19 and he's old.
What, an old fart?
Yeah, it's an old fart.
An old cuss?
Yes.
Getting old before his time.
is due.
Yeah, it's just an old dude.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Maybe saying this old guy, not even a dude.
He's mad. He's mad.
Yeah.
Let him be mad.
He's mad that my girlfriend's very young.
It's your life. It's your life. He's not.
Yeah, I know.
It's your life. Do whatever you want.
He's mad my girlfriend's very young.
Yeah. How about?
Ask him when he dated his. How old was he and how old was the girl that he used to date?
I don't know.
My thing is, I don't want to date
someone who's 30. They're old. That's too old for me. 18, 19, 20, 21, that's a good age.
And I didn't want to date men that were 30. You know, your grandfather and I got married when he was 25 and I was 18.
My girlfriend likes that I'm 32. She likes that. She likes it.
Yeah.
She's 19. I'm 32. Yeah. We're happy.
So what?
We're happy.
I always dated men not well 30 from 18 to 30 was a little bit too old for me. Yeah.
No.
All right.
Yeah.
Everybody's different.
Back in my time.
In your time.
All right.
My girlfriend doesn't care.
It's only numbers.
Yeah, it's only numbers. It ain't shit.
Yeah.
Let's see if she's done. Where is she?
Where's Joshua?
He's home.
Is he listening in?
Probably watching.
What? He's watching?
He watches.
I'm saying, Joshua, whatever I've said about personal family things, don't take it serious. Okay?
Yeah.
This is the way Grandma feels, and that's the way it is. And I love you for being there so many times for me, and I really appreciate it.
I appreciate you, Grandma. I appreciate Josh.
Now, I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. Just that, that isn't, no. You children are still important to me. You always will be.
Yeah.
Who was that?
That was what?
Who got girl?
I don't know. Well, it's just random people on my feet. I don't know. That's a guy. I don't know any of these people.
Oh, that's a guy? Oh.
Oh, that's the guy who is... I was at some bar when I was in New York. And this guy followed me on Instagram. This is called Instagram.
Yep.
It's just Instagram. It's just people's feeds. She doesn't know what Instagram is. She doesn't know Instagram.
No.
This is my girlfriend, Lauren. Lauren!
Where she's at now?
She's in South Carolina.
No, I mean at the residency where she resides. I mean now.
She's home.
Oh, nothing wrong with that? It was a long day.
Fuck. My stomach hurts.
Are they in the same time zone we are in?
Yes, yeah, South Carolina, Grandma. Yeah, it's Lauren.
Same as Florida, right?
Yes.
Okay, I don't know. You know, different time zones. I'm sure there's a limit, a border, or whatever you call it for time change.
Bronx, Barmer, Japan. Yeah, I went to Japan, Grandma.
What, for like a week?
For 1 week. I wanted to stay longer. It's not expensive.
I never found out what happened.
What happened to your puppy?
Like,
my puppy. My dog's at my mom's.
Oh, your mother kept him for you?
Oh, a friend did.
Oh.
A friend in L.A. did.
Oh, that's...
He didn't really want to watch the dog, but he did.
Oh.
I would have stayed for 2 weeks.
Oh, really?
I would have stayed for a month.
Really?
It's cheap.
2 weeks was
to what?
Go to Japan.
Wow.
I spent $20 to $30 a night on a hotel.
Really?
But it's very small. It's a pod.
Who do you care?
It's a pod. Like,
you wanted to go on.
You want to? Here, let me show you. This is what I stayed in Japan.
Okay.
But you were mainly on tour. Well, I wouldn't care.
No, I wasn't on a tour. I was by myself. I was alone.
Be surprised. What I'm.
Here, look.
One room.
Look, they have hotels in Japan, and they're called pods or capsule hotels.
Okay.
People sleep in these.
Okay.
This is how you save money in Japan. You have to, like, crawl into it.
All right.
Wow.
Look, I stayed at this one. This one right here, I stayed here. 9 hours, I stayed at this hotel before.
Okay.
I actually stayed at this hotel.
Wow.
Okay.
So when you first get there, they give you a bag. And in the bag, you get a towel, you get toothbrush or toothpaste. You live in one of those.
All right.
And soap.
Soap. Well, no, there's soap in there.
Oh, you mean
there's a dispenser, yeah.
Oh.
You get a locker.
A locker, really?
You get a locker, you get everything. So when you get there, you take your shoes off and you put them in your locker.
Yeah, you take them off.
And they give you slippers because they're slippers for indoors. So, see, she's putting on her slippers, and you're only supposed to wear them indoors.
Right. But it was, like, really tight. Any windows or nothing?
There was a big window in front of my pod.
Oh, okay.
There's a bath. Oh, the bathrooms there are crazy. The toilets are, like, all automated. It's like a smart toilet.
Oh.
And it has a bidet. It cleans your ass with warm water. Yeah, this is what you live in.
Is it called Toto?
Toto.
You press the button and it rinses you off.
Yeah, it rinses you off.
In Japan. I don't know if they still call it.
Look, and you live it. You stay in one of those. It's a pod.
Okay.
It's really nice. Like, I enjoyed myself there.
Do you have control of the temperature?
In there, not really. It's usually kind of cold in there. So you keep your slippers outside.
Yeah.
And then you have a little blind so you can close it. There's a light in there. There's a place to charge all your stuff.
Okay.
I've been in tight places that I was residing at, living at.
Yeah? Well, that's because you didn't really have a choice.
Well, show me some of the restaurants. Wow. Did you eat there?
I did.
Did you? Okay.
I went
How did you know where to go to eat?
I didn't. I just stopped at random places. Like, one morning, I stopped at a random little restaurant, and I had... What was that? What did I eat? I don't even remember. I remember there was, like, these little fish on the rice, though. They were good. They were, like, super salty. I think it was, like, mackerel. It was, like, a mackerel something.
They do more anchovies, right? They don't have them, those? Man, I had that one time. Ooh.
I like anchovies.
Yeah, that was salty.
Mainly ice and rice.
Rice and fish. That's what they eat.
That's what they eat.
They like rice and fish a lot.
How do you know how to order if you can't...
They have Japanese. They have English menus.
They have it in English.
Or there's a term. What was that term? I learned... What was that? It was like my last 2 days that I learned a term. And it's like a recommendation. Mm. Like, what would you recommend?
So how much were the... If you went in and sat down and ordered...
Yeah. I had sushi. I ate a lot of ramen.
What is that?
Ramen. Noodles.
Ramen noodles, like that.
Yeah, noodles.
Like this.
What's inside the noodles?
Nothing. It's like soup and noodles. And then there's like, they put egg in there.
How'd you know how to tip?
Oh, you don't tip.
No tipping?
Yeah, in Japan, it's,
not customary?
Yeah, you're not supposed to. It's rude.
Ah. You mean insulting?
Yeah, yeah.
How'd you know how to pay?
It's insulting. Because it tells you, like, the yen. You want to go to Japan, Grandma?
No.
Why?
I don't want to go. I'd love to go back to the country that London and Paris.
You want
to
go to London?
Scotland.
You want to go to London?
Yeah.
Would you go on a trip with me? I'll pay for it. My chat will pay for it, but we have to stream it, the entire thing.
What does that mean?
That means they get to watch us go on a trip. The viewers, these people, my viewers, my friends, this is my second family. These people are family to me.
I'd love to go back to Rome.
You want to go to Rome?
Yes.
Is that if you could go anywhere on the planet, you would want to go to Rome?
I want to go to Rome.
I think that would be a very, very, very interesting.
Scotland, Ireland.
Yeah, but
I went to Germany, but that I would not. They had a tour. I did not want to go to anything bad during the war, Holocaust, or any of that. I didn't want to ruin my vacation in Germany. I did not go. I didn't want to go near those places. I know it's history. Don't get me wrong. I know it's all history.
Take Grandma. They said take her to Rome.
I wouldn't go.
You wouldn't let me take you to Rome?
Some of the people went.
Let me take you to Rome. Buses. No, fuck the tour buses. We're just going to go to Rome. And we're going to rent a car and we'll just drive.
The Eiffel Tower was closed. I didn't get to go up in that. I wanted to go in Paris.
You want to go?
In Paris.
We can go. We can go. You want to go? I'll take you. I just have to save money. We'll take my grandma for content. Fuck it, dude.
You don't go there for these countries. On the tour, I had to pay half to get the tour going. And before I left here, I had to pay the other half. I was working at Walmart. Like I say, I saved my money very careful. Paid the bills. All my bills were paid first. And for eating, I would eat dollar dinners, you know. I would get by a bag of lettuce and tomato. Very careful eating, buy my food, and I paid before I left here. And the man that made up my tours for me,
yeah,
would drive me from my house to the airport.
Nice.
And when I came back, he would come and pick me up.
Nice.
But I only left from Fort Lauderdale.
They said, I'll donate if Grandma goes. I'll take you on a trip. Fuck it, dude.
No.
I'll take you on a trip. Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go?
She Pick said one country. Italy.
Italy. Italy?
She said that.
Oh, I would love to go back to Andre Bocelli's home.
You want
to
go see his home?
I've got a book, I told you. It's on his whole life up till whenever.
Yeah. Grandma, am I no good?
He had two beautiful sons.
Am I no good?
What do you mean you're no good? What do you mean?
Someone said the boy is no good, Grandma.
What in good?
Someone said that I'm no... They said the boy's no good. That's what they said about me.
Get out of town. You don't know him. I know Justin and Joshua. I know my grandchildren.
Roman Coliseum?
What are you talking about?
Do you have a passport?
Yes, I have. I have to upgrade it.
Update it. Update it and we'll go. No, I'm serious. Update it, we'll go. I'm not joking. I have my passport right there.
Why are they saying you're no good?
I don't know.
They don't even know you.
Boy's no good.
You
Richard
judge
tipped
people?
$2. Negers.
I don't know.
It's
Ask him.
Slang.
What are you saying? What are you saying? What does that word mean?
What's the first time I ever heard it? It's probably something really nasty, dirty, filthy, or...
I don't know what they're saying, dude. They're saying some wild shit today.
Ask him what it means.
Yeah, what does it mean, dude?
You know what?
Speak English. Hello.
He's not. He's purposely
Why?
Doing it.
Why?
Because he thinks he's, you know, like he went to college.
Don't
or
call
something.
Back then if you can't speak English, okay?
What
no
about?
No slang words or whatever. Whatever you're trying
Let's
to
Let's talk
say.
About something positive.
They can't,
this
talk,
is,
they can't
this
speak.
This is negative.
I don't know, dude.
What about Pompeii? Seeing what that looks like. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Guess who was there at Pompeii?
Who?
You, see the video. Pink Floyd plays Pompeii. They do different things about Pompeii, and they're performing, too. They do a long musical set.
Did you celebrate this yet, Grandma?
What is that?
The U.S. defeats the Netherlands. 2-0 to win the United States Women's World Cup.
You know where it's on?
Yeah, America.
It's on Telemundo, Channel 51.
America.
Right. But
America. Yeah. But it's America.
It's soccer.
We
right?
won.
Soccer.
We won.
Is that all
is that
now?
Soccer?
Yeah, we won.
Soccer.
We beat them at their own game,
soccer.
Grandma.
Soccer.
Yes. Semifinals.
Yes,
over
I saw
with?
That.
How come the men's team can't do it?
I didn't see the whole thing.
How come the men's team can't do it? How come the men's team can't do it?
Yeah.
No, I'm serious. I'm serious.
I don't understand the scoring of soccer. But I've watched that because of the United States. Yeah, I watched it. Not the whole thing.
I don't know.
Leaning Tower Pisa. You know, I don't know everything, but if you went to some of those, it would be like you're like doing this.
America!
Listen, a window.
How many people are in this country? How many people are in this country?
That can be punched up.
How many people are in this country? Was it like 200 million?
No, it's at least diversity. Or maybe like,
how many people are in the United States? Okay, so we have 325 million people in this country. All right? 325 million people.
That were born
How
here.
Fucking hard is it to find 11 people to kick the fucking ball around? How hard is it? How hard? I don't understand. All these other countries seem to be able to manage. We can't find 11 people to kick a ball around. 11 males. We're the greatest at everything. But right. We're the greatest at everything. How come we can't find 11 people to kick a ball around?
Open auditions.
Yeah, I'm sure they have, but how come we can't find these people?
I don't know. That's a mystery to me.
How do we have so many people? And we can't find 11 people just to win more trophies. We're great at everything. We're great at football. We're great at baseball. We're great at everything.
Basketball.
We're great at everything.
Basketball's incredible.
This is the shit that I think about, Uncle Sigurd.
Yeah.
Yeah. How come we can't find 11 people in this country to kick a fucking soccer ball around? How hard is that? How hard is it? Yeah. I mean, come on. Are we serious? Are we seriously
You watch on the educational channels?
What?
You ever heard of him? Rick Stevens?
No.
Oh my gosh. He does all kinds of countries.
Soccer coach? Now, I'm not a soccer coach. I'm just concerned about this country. And our soccer players.
Right.
Where the fuck are they? Where the fuck are they? We have so many people in this country. Right. There's got to be 11 people who are really, really, really good. Right. Where are our autistic soccer players? We have autistic.
Yeah.
We have autistic yep. baseball players
yeah.
that are so autistic, they just know how to hit a ball every single time.
Yeah.
That's their autism. Their autism is, I know how to hit the baseball.
Right.
We have autistic football players that just right. know how to throw a ball really far.
Yeah.
That's all they're good at is throwing a ball really far. We right. have autistic ball players that can just catch a ball really well every single time. How do we have all these fucking people, but yeah. we can't find 11 people to kick a ball around?
Wow.
Give it up.
You know what, Grandma? I think we have enough room to have more
Yes,
people
the U.S.
come
women,
in.
Women, the women.
No, I'm saying people come in. We are getting to the point where we're going to be like saturated, overpopulated.
Yeah.
You know what? You know the worst kind of areas
what?
Of the United States? That's where some people are going to have to live.
Oh.
You know, like deserts and yeah.
I'm not living in no desert, Uncle Sam.
Neither am I. I find some way of stopping it.
It's not that popular in America. Let's make it more popular.
It's bad.
Calm down, you ran Granny off. She had to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, some things are protected anyway, like parks.
Yes, USA women just won the World Cup. Congratulations. Yeah. Now let's get the men's team, and we're golden here in America.
Yeah.
We're golden.
Like I said, that channel and some people went absolutely crackers. Because it was an earlier of the semifinals of soccer. And I'm trying to remember which one was viewed. Wasn't it the United States versus England?
What?
One of the soccer meets was the United States versus England. or something like that. And people were going crazy. They were doing this. They were jumping up and down.
When was this?
Well, I go to a hall in South Florida, in Hollywood, Florida.
No.
And they have like a plasma, but it's not very big. Not a big, see how big that is? That's theater TV. Imagine it being a quarter of its size.
This is a theater TV. Yes, this is a theater TV, boys. Let's show them. We have to show them.
Yeah, but...
Theater TV, boys.
Yeah.
Ayo!
Yeah. You can see practically anything on there, but you can't show because of copyright, remember?
This is an old TV, Uncle Siggy.
Yeah, yeah, oldie but a goodie. Hitachi. Yes, it is.
Grandma.
What?
You should get a projector.
Projector for what?
So you can watch movies on your wall.
I don't know.
You have a bigger screen.
What?
It's bigger.
I have dim lights. It's big.
No, Uncle Siggy.
No, I mean, it's big.
Have you seen the projectors? A projector.
Not only I don't sit close, but I don't have the volume really super loud.
Grandma, you know they have TVs that you can fit on your wall now. You can take a TV and put it on your wall for like $200 or $300.
Yeah. I'm happy with this.
Okay. I'm just saying it's good quality.
I'll even move that if you want me to.
She don't even care. She don't even care, boys.
They have one of those, like I had mentioned about channels, as in big channels, at this hall I go to. I've been going there since August 2016. It was on a Wednesday.
Really?
Yep, that's all it's been. They have different activities going on. We're doing a memorial for somebody, Vinny Vincent. Guess what happened?
What?
He tried to get up in the morning, dropped dead.
Who did?
Vinny or Vincent.
Who's that?
A person who would come in the community hall.
I'm sorry.
Yep. War Memorial Regional South.
Oh.
It's connected with medical.
Right on.
Yep.
People are asking about you.
Well, I'm expressing myself because I like to go to, like, senior meets.
Is that Elton John?
It is Elton John.
What's his real name?
Reginald Kenneth Dwight, because I found it from my sister. She knew the name. She saw it in a magazine.
What's the name?
Reginald Kenneth Dwight.
What's Eddie Van Halen's real name?
Oh, Van Halen?
Yeah, what's Eddie Van Halen's real name? Is that his real name?
Oh, they show it. I don't know all of it now. I mean, gosh. There's two Van Halen brothers in it. In Van Halen, though.
Yeah, tell us.
They're Dutchmen.
Yes.
Eddie Van Halen.
Yes.
Yeah, but I don't know. I think the other one is Wolfgang Van Halen.
Oh.
I'm serious. Yes. But they're not my high in the priority of my favorite band.
Who are the high in priority? Who are the higher priority ones? Who are the higher priority?
From 1965, 1994. And then it popped in at 1997. You know who?
Who? The Who?
Nope. Pink Anderson.
Beach Boys.
Nope. Pink Anderson, Foley Council. Two Georgia Bluesmen.
What?
Pink Floyd. See, the name's in there.
Oh. Is that your passport?
I like The Who. I saw The Who. 1989.
Saw The Who? It's,
yeah.
The, you who seen stands. The Beach Boys?
No. Because they couldn't tour because they were getting poor ticket sales.
No.
It was different for them to tour. No. You get poor ticket sales, it's not high priority.
Tell me about The Who. Tour.
Like I said, I saw them in 1989 in South Florida. And it was the tour when he had passed away in 1978. Keith Moon. That's his real name. People think it's a made-up name.
Yeah.
He died.
Yeah.
And he wasn't around. So they had Kenny Jones, a replacement drummer, tour with him.
Uncle Sigurd loves Pink Floyd.
Yeah, but The Who was... unbelievably great, and they were extremely loud for open air concert. Oh my gosh, you should have been there. You would have loved it.
No,
I brought in some beach balls.
Yeah.
Ew. They didn't stop me. I brought in four of them, you know, just
What's the name of the drummer from Rush?
I don't follow him that close. That's the problem.
You don't like Rush?
No, I don't.
Why don't you like Rush?
I like because of the name of Geddy Lee, but I don't know everybody. I don't. I listen to him, but I like to move around and listen to groups. Not because they're Canadian, by the way. I know some Canadians. No problem.
You like the Canadians?
Yeah, but I'm.
He loves them.
I'm close to some Canadians.
He loves them.
And there's two Canadian large communities in South Florida anyway.
His name is Neil. Neil. Peart.
Okay. What's his question?
No, that's the drummer's name.
Oh, Neil Peart.
Rush is amazing.
They're pretty loud too. They were at the Hollywood Sportatorium, but I didn't go.
Oh.
And
what about Ozzy?
John Ozzy Osbourne.
Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah. I was in a small, I'll tell you a story. I didn't get the signature because I was only allowed one signature. And I got it on the menu of the small club called, ready folks? The Treehouse. It doesn't exist anymore, but it was off of Dixie Highway. Guess who was there?
Jean-Philippe tipped $2. Hello, I'm Satan. I work for NASA in collaboration with the aliens. Learn Mandarin, the flood is coming, go to China, it will be the last kingdom on earth. Eat my perfect porn Subway sandwich pussy. I'm Justin in retard, I fuck like a retard, I'm a weed addict.
Alright, can we carry on? At the treehouse, I'm sitting there, and guess who's sitting there? Just walks in off the street.
Who?
Part of Black Sabbath.
Hey!
But Ozzy Osbourne wasn't with him because Ozzy Osbourne was ousted by Tommy Iommi.
Oh.
He took over the lead singing duties. But I asked them one question. I was even going to get them some beers. They said, no, you have the menu? You got a pen? Sign their name.
Nice.
All these are still in the package.
Yep.
What is it?
Coins.
You got coins?
Yeah. Yeah.
Grandma's got the coins.
Yeah. They're in the original, numbered and everything. These
coins. Ew.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, the whole point is, if you're polite with people and you're low-key and laid-back and you don't get pushy, you can meet somebody.
Yeah, you can.
I can't believe it. And I gave it to Dave, and Dave was stunned. He goes like, no kidding. It wasn't Ozzy Osbourne, but you got these signatures on the menu, and they did it for you, and they weren't really asking anything of you. He still got it to this day. Dave, ready?
My
Dave,
dad.
Dave Biente.
My you dad? Talk?
Have you ever seen Dave Biente.
Oh, I thought you meant David Schwimmer.
No.
Look at it.
No,
what
different.
Is it? Just look at it.
What is it?
They're all numbered and everything.
It's a nickel.
I know.
Yeah. What year? See.
It's uncirculated too anyway.
Oh, yeah.
It's worth some money.
Some of these coins, they're not circulated. That's why I
never
got
touched
it.
My human hands.
Why are his eyes all weird?
I don't know, because it's Thomas Jefferson. That's
no, this was circulated.
Sure?
His face is fucking scuffed.
Is it?
Why is his face scuffed? Where did you get this?
Huh?
I know. Oh, you gotta be careful when you put them in there, because they get more scuffed.
I'm very. No.
Were these circulated or no? These are circulated.
They are?
Were these in circulation, these? You gotta be careful with coins.
JGT, anyway, $2. Hang on. SJC, this is literally UIN 20 years. Same situation to living with your mom just like Uncle Cigarette. Really?
I don't know. Thank you for $2, though.
No. I wanted to finish the story because I was trying to finish it and the guy was interrupting.
What he's saying is just, you know, oh, you keep shit on it.
I'm not saying on that. I'm putting this
okay,
right here.
Okay, good. Anyway, to wrap up the story about an encounter with somebody famous, they basically were in South Florida, and it was like they were relaxing, and they were trying to get together for the next release of a music with the band.
Do you know anyone in Pennsylvania? I want to order some of those Laura moved.
Yeah.
In Pennsylvania, we went up to the Amish country, and I want to get those candles. I've got them in every window.
Yeah.
But I had to get them in a gift shop there.
Yeah. What are you asking for? You want candles?
They'll come on at night. No, they're two batteries. There's no address or anything. In every window in my house, I've got the candles. They'll come on after dark.
They're illuminated.
I want to know.
Illumination.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
No.
What?
No.
What?
What is she talking about?
Talking about candles that are not real, but they illuminate at night. They're illuminous.
No.
But they're not dangerous. They only are facsimiles.
I don't know what that means. What's a facsimile?
I'm going to show you. Look in my window.
Of candles. She's got them all around. She bought them that time she went up to Pennsylvania.
I bought them in Pennsylvania in the gift shop. I don't remember the gift shop.
Yeah.
We went to so many of them.
Yeah.
When,
Souvenirs.
Souvenirs.
Keepsakes. However.
Really, dude.
However, getting through it. It sure has happened to people. I'm sure it has.
And it must be some way, somehow, I can order some more. It's in the Amish country.
Anyway, getting back to the point, Dave originally hailed from New Jersey. And the whole point is, he came down with his family, and he wanted to try and improve himself. And you know what he did? He went to California. He's in California somewhere. If you see a name, Dave Biente, that's him.
Yeah.
I never heard his middle name, though. That's the problem. Maybe he wasn't born with one. That does happen to some people. Maybe he actually did something with his guitar work. He tried. And you know what else he was trying? I saw some sampling of it. Words, lyrics. So maybe he had some kind of career going on. What do you think? Maybe?
Maybe.
As an indefinite maybe?
Yeah.
Because you know who you like, though, don't you?
Who?
Black Sabbath. Who was, who was the front man prior to 79? John Ozzy Osbourne. He wrote to him, too. He loved him.
Yeah.
A frantic fan. A frantic fan. What does that tell you?
It's interesting.
Yeah. As in mildly interesting. I only did it for him because I said, you know, I'm only going to get this one chance. And that treehouse was an institution. It was an icon. Everybody flocked to it. Even somebody famous, I already showed you, somebody famous walked in. So anything's possible.
That's interesting.
I was pretty young at the time, too. What do you expect for in the midst of the, after 1980, prior to 1989? It was the 80s, man. Yep. Wow. It's quite like a short story there. Of close encounters, even though I was doing it for somebody else, he didn't know what was going on. He had to think about it for a while because he really didn't know that it had happened. But I said, hey, you know what my tip to you is?
It's still open. It's ready for business. Why don't you go to the treehouse and check it out for an evening? See what I went through. No guarantees about anybody, but you'll be entertained.
Okay, dude.
Yeah, I had the address and phone number and everything on it anyway, of the menu. Wow. You know, I met myself, but I was polite not to really get overbearing, pushy, you know, just getting too excited. You know who was on the Johnny Carson show in rotation of, being a guest host? You won't believe me. Comedian David Brenner. If now he's still alive. He came into the mall there that I was at. It was a Sunday. It was somewhat in the morning. You know what he was doing? Well, the reason I'm in here in this hall of the mall here, and there's a lot of places of business, I'm looking for something for my son because it's his birthday.
Pick it up, Uncle Siggy.
It's for his birthday. Something Western.
Don't answer.
Hello. Are you calling my grandma's house, really, faggot? Bro, don't call my grandma's house. Bro, the people, they're calling. They're calling. They found your house number. Why? Yeah, don't answer the phone anymore.
I never do.
Why
never.
Why are you calling? I look at who's calling.
Yeah, you can monitor.
I never answer my phone without... If I don't know the number, why are they calling?
Because they're obsessed.
Obsessed with what?
Some viewers are obsessed with me. So then they'll call places where I'm at and harass me.
Look at some of these coins. I've collected these.
The half dollar or dollar, the Ike dollar there, the big one.
Holy shit.
You know what the Ike dollar was done?
That's a 1973 penny.
Yep. Richard Milhouse Nixon was in presidency then.
Oh, look at this. You're not going to believe this.
Yeah. Oldies but goodies.
There's some pretty rare coins here.
You know who this is?
That is your mom.
No,
JT tipped $2. Uncle Cigarette, this is John. I saw you in Overtown really late last night talking to two blacks on TH Street.
Where's that?
What were you trying to score?
Total lie.
That's her mom.
No, it's not.
Who is this?
No, it's not. You're doing the wrong thing.
That's, I don't know who this is. This is your mom.
No, that's Sig's mom.
Oh, holy shit. I don't know who that is.
He doesn't even
never
know
met
I
her.
Have these pictures.
I never met
one
her.
Fell. Where is it?
Right here.
In front of you.
Now,
see it? Right there.
No, that his.
Oh. No.
Bro, don't start. Here, I'm turning the caller off.
Don't answer the phone. Just let it ring.
Yeah. They don't like if something's being recorded.
I don't care.
We're in control. They're not.
Bro, I'm turning all these ringers off. These people are fucking crazy. There. Now you can keep calling and calling and calling and talk to nobody.
You're not going to believe this. I want you to look at this.
No problem.
It's Josh's hair.
It is.
It's no. It's a viewer of mine, Uncle Sigurd. Don't pay it any mind.
Okay.
Don't pick up the phone.
I'll listen. It's called monitoring.
What do you want? Stop harassing my family, retard. Maybe I should give people your number.
How'd they get?
I have your number right here, buddy. All right, who wants this guy's number?
My mother could write it down and use it.
Anyway,
I'm sure it's happened to you, Justin.
Do you want to see
somebody
these?
Famous?
Wait, yes. When you look at these.
Yes, I want to see.
Look at these. You're in there. You believe that?
That's fucking old.
You see yourself?
Yeah, there's me.
Yeah, you. Grandma, I took those pictures. I kept them all these years.
Justin. You see this? Justin.
Yes.
It's on the floor.
Oh, thank you, Uncle Sigurd.
Yeah, I wonder if somebody stepped on it.
Well, who's here?
Mom, I saw it, okay?
There's me. There's Josh. And there's my grandpa. And that's Randy.
Here.
Look at this.
Yeah. That might be worth something.
I mean, it's not taken out of the packaging. Holy shit. There's only 25,000 of these. I wonder how many people didn't take these out of the packaging. I mean, if the packaging were a lot better, it would have been good. But, you know...
Yep, so I found that.
Oh, you found it? It's worth something.
Anyway, that large coin that's a... Just hear who it is, if they've got some nerve.
Call from private caller.
Fuck off, Josh.
I gotta get going because they're gonna keep harassing you. Hello.
Yes. Don't tell me what to do. Don't tell me what to do. Don't tell me what to do. Hello. You're obsessed.
I would just let them. Like that.
Alright, I gotta get going, Grandma.
Why?
Because they're gonna keep harassing you as long as I'm here.
Yeah. What?
I gotta get going. I'm gonna go home because I wanna go eat. But I'll be back. I'll be back.
Alright.
I'm right down the street.
I know where you are.
I'm gonna move in. Okay, I will not let your cat out.
A couple of times, he can go out in the back because that gate's locked. He can't get out.
JJ?
But you not? Yes, he will. He'll be out and gone. I don't want anything to happen to him now. I take very good care of him, and I don't want anything to happen.
Do whatever you want to do. You're here. Go. Have you seen your father?
No. Well, yes, why? Kind of. Not even Justin. Really. I have not seen my dad since I've been here. I've not seen my...
He's your father. You need to go and see your father.
I have not seen my dad once.
Just let it ring.
They're going to keep calling you, Grandma.
Why do they keep...
Because they're obsessed.
You said as long as you're here, they're going to keep calling?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they're crazy. Some people get wild.
What do they want to know? What do
they just... I don't know. They just want to talk to you.
What... Talk to me about what?
Who knows, Grandma?
Did you, like I say, tomorrow I'm going to go to Memorial.
Okay, I'm going to be here.
Do not let him out.
All right. All right.
I don't want anything to
I happen. Love you, Grandma.
Okay. Where's Sigurd? Where's it? All right. I love you.
I live here. You want to go have you want to go have lunch tomorrow? We'll do anything, anytime you want. I don't care. I live down the street. You know my number.
Of course, I know your number.
Can I just live here? Do you have room for me?
I just told you what I want.
Well, you have to move all that stuff out.
And I have to go and get a bed. I want to get one of those. A bed
Big Lots.
That can open up.
Where do you think I got mine?
I just need somewhere to live.
Big Lot.
Like, this is the room I'm in, but we got to move all this shit out. There's a lot of stuff in here. I need to be able to put a desk here. Maybe I'll use this as a desk. I'll clear all that out and use this as a desk.
But what are you going to do? I want it packed the way I want it packed.
Okay, I need a place to put my computer. I need to be able to put my TV. Yes, I need to put a TV in here.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I'm moving in. Yeah. Where can we put all this? Can we put it in the attic?
In what?
The attic upstairs.
What? No, nothing goes there. No. I'm just going to have to box things and put them where I know where they are.
Oh, okay. I'm just saying, I'm going to, you know, I need room. I'm going to need to put TV. I'm going to have to put everything, the TV.
Why didn't you call me ahead of time so I could get all
this did.
Boxed up and cleared out of
well,
here?
Well, take your time. Take your time. I'll help you.
I got to go get boxes and I got to do them myself.
I'll help you clean it. I mean, if you want to do it, I mean, shit.
I told you what I got to do tomorrow.
All right. I mean, I got to figure out what I'm going to do here. All right. We'll be back, Grandma. I love you.
Okay, be careful.
I'm going to be very careful. I'm coming back.
Do you need something to eat? I mean...
I'm going to go to my mom's.
And then y'all going to eat?
I don't know what I'm going to do. Look, I'm just lightheaded.
Bye,
Uncle Sigurd.
I want you to give me... I don't want you to go in any detail of what we talked about.
Okay.
Personal thing.
Well, they probably know because I'm live on the internet. So my brother knows what we talked about, but not my mom.
I don't want you to get in any argument or anything
I love you
there.
Very much.
What I've told you.
I love you.
You know?
I'll be back.
Like I say, Brent has all. Listen to me.
Yes.
He's always been very nice to me.
I'm sorry. I'm lightheaded. I have not eaten one thing today. I'm going to pass out. I have not eaten all day. I did not eat since last night. I'm just tired.
home from school one day with a shiner on my eye. Fighting was against the rules and it didn't matter why.
Listen to boys, we're in Florida. We in, do I smell fireworks? We're in motherfucking Florida, what you mean, bro?
What do you mean, dude?
Oh, here. This is from Linda. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah, Linda. Linda knows what's up.
Dude, we back.
Hey, what's going on, Brent? Yeah, I just went to see my grandma for a little. Where's my mom? Hey, what's going on? What are you making?
Do you remember that?
What type of cookies are these?
He was army camp.
Are these Republican cookies?
Yeah. And you came back in your golf club.
Are these for your Trump group?
No, it's a Republican group.
Remember that?
Is it for your Republican group?
Yeah, what do you think?
Is that what you're making them for?
I'm never playing golf again.
Let's go play golf, Brent. No, I want to go play golf. When are you playing golf?
Yesterday.
Are you playing tomorrow?
Nope. I have a job interview tomorrow.
Okay, nice. Don't tell us where. Congratulations. I wish you. What do you mean?
I'm watching you. Don't copyright strike me because I'm watching you.
Hey, copyright strike.
Don't copyright
strike. How do you like my new shaker cup? Do you like that? It's the PewDiePie shaker cup.
What kind is mom making? Trump cookies?
Mom's making Trump cookies.
Oh my fucking god.
She's making Republican cookies.
We gotta make fucking donkey cookies. We gotta go to Publix and see if they have donkey.
Why?
Because, you know, Republicans, Democrats, but
I'm not a Democrat.
Okay, I'm independent, so we just need to get... What shape do I need to get if I'm an independent?
You should get an I for independent.
No, that's...
Wait, which one should I try first? Which one of these flavors should I try?
I'm looking at you like, hey, let me get that, but it's G Fuel? Fuck that shit.
You want some G Fuel?
Yeah.
Hey, G Fuel? I mean, okay, so let me tell you. So if you want some G Fuel,
yeah,
what are you going to use it for?
I don't know what G Fuel is.
It's to keep you focused. It's energy.
Oh, focus, energy. Now I'm good.
I don't know. Do you game? It's to help you focus on video games.
Ask me that question again.
Josh only plays Grand Theft Auto.
Do I game?
Can I ask you a favor? Can you buy a TV so I can game with people, with my fans while I work all day? Look, I'm going to go work with you, okay? Stop. Shut up. Everybody knows I'm going to go work with you. Shut up. Everybody knows. It's not a secret. I'm going to go work with Josh. Who gives a fuck? Stop it.
No, you're not.
So if I'm going to be there 5 days a week, 6 days a week.
No.
Stop talking.
No.
My PSN is SJC. _official. We'll play Grand Theft Auto.
No.
Yes. I'm going to play. I promise you. I'm going to sit. Give me the little one. We're going to play Grand Theft Auto.
Here, take this.
No, I don't want this.
It's clean. It's nice. It's new. And it's not your little crack one. It's a nice nectar collector.
Can I do a review on it? Do you sell these? Can I sell these? All right. I'm going to do a review on this. I'm going to review this nectar collector. I've never used this one. This is, okay.
You're letting it get too cold.
But.
Yeah.
No, I won't. Because I'm not streaming.
Just keep it there.
I'm only going to be playing video games and, but you get a discount if you show up. But you get a discount. I'm giving discounts.
Where's my little pouch?
I'm giving discounts. Let me see. Stop. Give me this. Homie. Pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Dude, Gene, Gene was saying the craziest shit to you. Oh, Gene. Oh, my God, dude.
Bro, you said some wild shit to my grandma.
He was saying the craziest shit to, my to Uncle Sigurd. Oh, my God. It was so fucking hilarious. Like, he even had Uncle Sigurd, like, speechless. Literally speechless.
Yeah, you had Uncle Sigurd speechless.
And he is a man hard to sit there to ponder something, you know? He's the Rain Man of music.
Yeah, he is the Rain Man
of music. I don't know if you got that or not.
Like, Uncle Siggy is the Rain Man of most music. Uncle Siggy is gonna have Uncle Siggy's gonna have his new podcast. You know what his podcast he's gonna be coming up with?
I was thinking about a good name for a podcast for him. What's a good name for him for if he did do a podcast?
Yes, Jumper. That sounds like a good name.
No, he's not gonna fucking.
Yes, Jumper sounds like a good name for
something cigarette related. Cause his
yes, name is no, Uncle yeah. Sick. Think about it. Think about it. Like, I don't know, I just came up with it. Like, it's called Yes Jumper. That's the name of the podcast. Yes Jumper or Yes Skipper. Yes Skipper sounds like a good name for a podcast.
Yes Skipper with your Captain Uncle Sig here.
Yes Skipper with your Captain Uncle Cigarette here. I think that'd be lit. We should take Grandma on a trip to Rome, Italy.
Yeah, I saw that. You mentioned that.
I think I'm down. I'm down to do that. I'm down.
Yeah.
Why not?
When's that happening?
Soon. I need to look. I need to bait. I need to bait some donos for Italy. Oh. We're gonna get some Italian donos.
I saw that. Whee! Uncle Fester, hell yeah.
Uncle Fester is the best. Fucking. Yeah!
Go get Nelly.
Nelly, come on over here. Nelly, come on.
Ew.
What's this dog doing? She's like, dude, jumping around.
Nelly,
like
getting into Nelly, what do we talk about? Where's your bed, Nelly?
Oi, Nelly. Lay down.
Show Justin where your bed
down.
Is.
Lay down your bed. Show lay down your bed. Down.
No.
Come here.
Show Justin where your bed is. Good that's girl. A good girl. All right, good that's girl. A good girl.
That's a good girl. Look at that, Nelly.
That's my baby.
It's yours.
That's my baby.
This is my baby.
I'm teaching her.
My baby. The best dog ever. No, right. My baby. No. Nelly!
Alright.
Good dog. Best dog ever. Come here. Say hi, Dad. Say hi, Dad.
You're a good girl.
I trained her, and she knows. Nelly! Justin, what did I train you?
Get off the bed!
What did I?
Off the bed! Let's go! Off the bed!
No, my baby. She gets the belly rub.
Is that good, babe? Is that good, little cocker? Is my little cocker? Dude, it's the best dog ever. I'm telling you. The best dog ever. She listens. It's super cute now. Yeah, baby. I love this fucking dog. No, you can't be up here. You can't be up here. You're so sweet. Sit.
Yeah, like I said.
Fuck it, dude. Fuck it, dude. Unscrupulous companies promise student debt relief.
Free nose
dabs.
Free nose
dabs. They can't deliver.
Yo, homie, nose dabs are $15. Nose dabs are $15 on my channel, by the way. Sorry to put it to you.
Net.
Where's Nell? That's a good girl. That's a good girl, Nell. You're on your bed. Aww. That's a good girl. Not to be a Jew. Josh Ahmad Blue.
Retard SJC doesn't understand that U.S. football can't grow because the systems that they have is shit.
Yeah, you...
We have 350 million people in this fucking country. You find 11 people out of 350 million fucking people, and we have a good fucking team. We have a good fucking team. We will fucking dominate the fucking world. 11 people. It's not that fucking hard. It's not rocket science. It's not like we're trying to find fucking Tiger Woods out there. I just want to see someone kicking a ball around. That's it. That's it. Greatest country in the world, my ass. Why? No, fuck you.
Simmer down.
Fuck you.
Simmer down.
Why we gotta... Why wait? What?
We're not outside.
What? No, I'm mad. I'm mad.
Relax.
I'm mad. 350 million people in this country, Josh.
Relax.
Josh, we're 350 million people in this country.
Yeah.
Okay?
And...
Why is our team shit? Why is our team shit?
Who's our?
The United States football team, soccer team, the motherfucking football team is shit.
Is it like the team qualifying for like the Olympics?
Shit. Pure shit. No, it's a team that competes on behalf of the United States for like World Cup and shit.
Yeah, the Olympics.
No, it's not that. That's not the Olympics. World Cup is different. Jesus Christ, you fucking ignorant motherfucker.
Oh, FIFA. You talking about FIFA?
Yes. World Cup. Yes. United States. Yes. I don't understand it. Why can't we get some players from Mexico? They're fucking amazing.
Because they have to be Americans. That's...
No, they gotta be born here. So what? LA has great players. What the fuck? You think I'm kidding? Joshua, we steal all of our great baseball players from Puerto Rico and Cuba. What's wrong with you, bro?
Well, here,
that's why we're
here,
the best in the fucking world.
Whoa, whoa, Florida.
We're the best.
Florida's baseball
the
team
best.
Is horrible.
Fuck you. You know
they
what?
Thought, they
shut
thought,
up.
They
shut
thought
up.
Game
1993.
They
1993.
Dead.
Shut your fucking face.
Dead.
1993.
Dead.
Go fuck yourself.
Dead.
No. 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 I don't give a shit.
Dead.
I don't give a shit. We had Pudge Rodriguez, alright? We had Pudge Rodriguez. Go fuck yourself. World Series champs, boys. And you know what they did?
Hey.
They fucked us.
I'm hard of hearing. Can you yell a little louder? You're scaring... I'm a little hard of hearing.
Puerto Rico is a U.S. That's what I'm saying! That's where we get our players from.
Holy,
they're on this fucking island.
Holy fuck.
This is what happens when you drink G Fuel. This is G Fuel. G Fuel at work, boys.
Go take that shit out back. Beautiful backyard. Beautiful backyard. Go.
But,
if you're going to be loud, go out back.
Listen here. Listen here. Let me fucking
you
finish.
You can use your outdoor voice in our beautiful
no,
backyard.
No. All right, calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Why the fuck do we have shit players? That's all I'm fucking saying. We focus on some shit that doesn't really fucking matter. We focus on our own fucking sports. But it's like, bro, fuck it. Let's dominate. Let's fucking dominate. Let's fucking dominate. What the fuck? Bro, I'm down to take my grandma on some dope trip. You fucking mean, bro? Down to take grandma on the trip. I love my grandma. Why wouldn't I go somewhere fucking dope with my grandma? My grandma probably knows more about the place than I do. That's why I would hang out with my grandma.
She told you about her honor flight?
Her what?
The honor flight thing.
A fight? Grandma got into a fight?
No, the honor flight. She showed you the t-shirt.
Tell me.
The hat that she was wearing. You didn't hear anything she was telling you, did you?
I listened.
So what is the honor flight?
Oh, that's where they fucking flew her to DC.
Okay.
They fucking... Free!
Fuck it, dude.
Oh, man. Oh, someone said they'll donate if you take a shower. That's a good opportunity.
Probably not.
I'd take some up on that. And that's simple. That's something I do every day.
I was forced to educate Grandma on why illegal immigration is wrong. I was forced to educate. Illegal immigration is horrible. It's a horrible thing. It is. Sorry, Andy, but you came here legally and you're born here, some shit, Andy. Pretty sure Andy was born here. Andy's fine.
Mexican Andy's.
He's Guatemalan.
He's a smart guy.
He's Guatemalan. Oh, he's very intelligent.
Guatemalan? We've been.
Hey, Brent. How are you? My chat wanted to talk to you for a minute.
About what?
On the illegals.
They need to stay back where they can't talk.
They're stealing our resources, Brent. How do we stop them from stealing our resources?
Ask their press.
I don't know.
Ask AOC and Nancy Pelosi.
I don't know.
And Chuck Schumer.
I don't know any of these people personally, so I can't really go ask them.
Well,
maybe I can try to send an email, but do you think they'll listen? Why is that one lady Cortez? Why is she like them here? Why is she like them here? What do you mean?
They're hoping that when they get here, eventually they'll get citizenship and they'll give her credit. So she wants all of them to come over here ASAP.
That's wild. That's not how it works. Are these people delusional? Are they delusional, Brent?
Yep.
Where are they getting these bright ideas from?
Month after month, the clock is ticking on irreversible joint damage. Ongoing pain and stiffness are signs of joint erosion.
Nelly, be good.
Humira can help stop the clock.
Be good, Nelly.
For 15 years, Humira targets and blocks inflammation that contributes.
Oh yeah, I forgot. I forgot. I brought something for your internet. Bro, what's wrong with the internet here at your house?
Okay.
The internet's not well. Oh, that's not good.
Talk to your rheumatologist. Right here, right now. Humera.
Fuck. That's fucked. I'm sorry for cussing.
Fuck your mama.
Sorry, Brent. Oh, here we go.
Babe.
What?
You took all the covers off. Hey, you know what came over.
Someone in my chat says that they believe in open borders. What does that mean?
Open borders means that anybody, whoever, can come across your border.
Are they right or are they wrong?
They're wrong.
Why? Why are they wrong?
There's immigration laws. You just can't just come walking over the border.
You can't just walk over the border, he said.
Brent, you have the brakes on? You need help? Brent, do you need help?
Someone in my chat said, here, I'll help you, Brent.
No.
That's Brent and his dad. That screams America. Right here.
I have to
See you later. It was nice meeting you.
Brent, you need help.
It was a pleasure.
It's a pleasure.
Well, Josh!
I'll see you later.
What I need to do is I need to move my car first.
Okay.
Up the gate.
So what?
So I pooped over here. Okay.
Did you eat it?
We're good.
Are you heading out?
Hey.
You leaving?
I'll see you. Yeah, I'm going. Okay. I'm going home because my family's all going someplace.
Okay.
So
I'll see you when you come back here.
Okay.
He was choking.
All right.
I didn't ground the food.
I appreciate you.
Thank you.
Nelly? No.
His food has to be ground up, like, you know, pureed.
Yeah, use the blender.
Mom, before I eat this cookie, I just want you to know something. I'm an independent.
Brent's dad has been a Republican for 75 years. Proud of it. He could teach you some. Oh, you like my cookies, huh? Look.
No, I'm just done.
Are they good?
Mm.
Was it a good recipe?
Have a good one.
Was it a good recipe?
It needs more sugar.
Do you need help?
It needs more sugar.
Huh?
Brent's just moving his car.
It needs more sugar.
You need.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Here, Brent. Are they good? You like my Republican cookies? Brent, do you need help? Get it down the. Josh, can you help him on the other side going down the.
Someone
outside the door.
Someone in my chat said, do you feel the burn?
No.
Let me help you.
See you later.
Yeah, Justin, you gotta watch his feet because his feet are messed up.
Okay.
Don't even touch his feet.
Easy. Here, Brett, let me do it.
I didn't vote for you. I feel like it's only right to make that point. Audio is scuffed. What do you think? This phone right here is so fucked up. Oh my god. We need to set you up on a.
I picked up the whole wheelchair. You see it?
We need to get you a new screen.
I know. I need a.
You like those damn Republican cookies?
It's $200 if I do it through my insurance.
Those, I'm going to make it my Republican club meeting.
So I either go through Shurion or Josh.
My first meeting.
Or Josh. I go and I get a new upgrade. I'm available for an upgrade soon.
There's no such thing as upgrade.
No, with Verizon?
Oh, Verizon, yeah.
Verizon? Yes, I have upgrades.
Why do you emphasize
Justin?
You saying Verizon?
Because it's a great company.
No, it's up that. Those
Mom, you should definitely switch to Verizon.
Verizon
is the best.
Hey, you gotta admit, these are pretty good.
No, it needs more sugar, I'm not gonna lie to you.
How sweet is this? Look at this gem.
Oh, look at that gem.
Look at this gem.
Look at that fucking gem.
Look at this gem.
Jesus Christ. Look at that fat bastard.
Hell yeah.
Look at that fat bastard. Goddamn turkey neck, mom vulgar. Who's fatter, Uncle Siggy or DJ? Thank DJ. Poor Linda.
Josh.
Yeah.
Are these good?
These cookies were good. And why do you emphasize Republican cookies?
Because it's a Republican club. Because
they're shaped as
an elephant.
An elephant?
What? Why can't they just be elephant cookies?
I mean, they're good.
Why can't they just be regular elephants?
Yeah, let them be regular elephants. Let the elephants live. Let the elephants live, Ma. Where'd my drink go?
Look, I have this one, which is even bigger. Look.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck it, dude.
Hey, isn't your phone waterproof?
Look.
Yeah, the screen's cracked.
Josh. You know what? I think that they need just a tiny, like...
I forgot to shake it.
Like, a couple... 30 seconds left, huh? Oh, my God, stop!
No, she's playing. Stop it. Leave her alone.
He doesn't want to.
Leave the dogs alone.
Nellie's horny.
Look at her.
She wants to play. Want to. No, it's not. It's called... It's dominance. Google it.
Well...
She's trying to put him on his back to show dominance.
Yeah, but you don't want sugar cookies like so.
You want them sweet. You don't want.
You
I don't
want
know.
Them that sweet.
I'm not.
You don't want them so sweet. Oh my God, I feel bad. I didn't ground this straight up enough. He's choking.
Mom. You almost made him choke.
He was.
Oh, Brent. Brent does not know how to take out salmon. Jesus, Brent. Mom, why don't you teach him how to take out salmon?
It's not salmon, it's salmon.
It's salmon. Read it. It's called salmon. How do you not know how to take out a piece of salmon?
Look.
Here,
could you
take
eat
the,
all that? What? Justin, could you eat all that?
Yeah. Y'all eat all that? How much?
Don't touch all that.
You gotta grab the flake right here. See, Brent grabbed it at the wrong area. Brent grabbed it at the wrong area. That's a big ass
cookies.
Piece.
You know when you smell that smell. Look at them. Look at those babies.
No, I farted, Mom. I'm sorry. Nice. This is how you take it off, Brent. Brent destroyed the salmon.
My God, we went to a restaurant last night. It was so ridiculous. $350.
Oh. Yeah, that's what happens when you go to some fake, authentic Italian place.
Oh, they had oysters. Nasty.
Oysters are really good for you.
They had East Coast oysters, not West Coast oysters.
It's good for you.
It's disgusting. I told Brent, I said, well, goddamn, I'm going to give you some stamina. Come on, buddy.
No, well, it's good for you.
That's a goober. That's disgusting. That's like snot.
No, it's actually a muscle.
It's like eating snot. Who eats snot?
It's a muscle.
Well, I'm sorry, but there's no flavor to this.
Yes, there is. It tastes like the ocean. And then when you add other flavors to it, it enhances it.
No, you don't even chew them.
Well, you don't need to. Maybe you eat it.
It's disgusting.
Food. You burnt them, Mom. Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
Bless you, Nellie.
See, those got a little done. Look. Those got done more than those did.
I thought there were like hamburgers and hot dogs. Where's this shit at?
In the microwave.
No, I don't want microwave hamburgers and hot
dogs. Ah! Shit! No, Nellie, goddammit.
The dog can eat sugar cookies.
No, it's hot.
Are these old hamburgers?
No.
These are old. It's Josh.
What happened?
I dropped a sugar cookie.
So you have to fucking scream like that?
Well, because Nellie was getting.
You have to fucking scream, Mom.
I just took it out of the oven.
You gotta scream like someone's fucking like robbing you or just. Oh my
Damn
God.
Damn it. How could one side get brown and the other side?
What would you do for a contact bar, Mom?
How could one side get brown like that and the other side didn't? Tell me.
No?
Thank you.
Mom.
Doesn't make sense.
Mom. Don't forget. Never forget. Obama was the greatest. Obama was amazing. And he did nothing but change.
Yeah, he divided his own people.
He made an impact on our lives. And he brought Obamacare. And it was never repealed and replaced with nothing.
I love you, those lies. Lies from your goddamn party.
I love you.
Bye.
Oh yeah. Can you? I need you to do me a favor. I need to do a return address change or dress change. I need to do an address change. Because I never did it. I forgot. So I still got mail going to Los Angeles. Yeah, I fucked up, right? I fucked up, Linda, alright? Get over it. Yeah.
What are you cooking?
I don't know. Merlin wants it. Well, you gotta be careful. You don't come over here. Can't come over here.
Why?
Some of the go in this area. Oh. Something about this house. I don't know what it is. That's why I have it there. You can't really. You're, look, you see how it dropped down to 700, 800. It's going back up because we're in this area.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. I don't get it.
So what's like
Justin,
a.
Now, how could you put this on the thing?
Oh, now it's at 9. 9, okay. Okay, I get it.
Huh?
Hey, Josh.
Hey, Justin.
You know what you can do?
No.
I got something for you. If you hook this up.
I don't want a PS4. Not interested.
You're not even listening. You didn't even let me finish. You just jump in.
If I want to hook a what up? Hook up what?
Hang on, homie. Goddamn. You just won't let me fucking find it, will you? I got something that'll make the internet better. Oh. I just gotta find it.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Listen, my party is helping you, so.
Well, I forgot you even had this.
Oh, I don't know how I brought it, but.
How's your party helping you?
Justin, are you able to live in this country?
I was able to live in here before this schmuck become president anyways.
Really? And what did he do to you?
He didn't do anything.
He's such a schmuck. What did he do to you that he's such a schmuck? Tell me. You listen to your father who has like 5 brain cells left. That's the problem.
Hang on, chat. I have to get something from my suitcase. Holy shit. Hi, Chanel.
Is that the infamous suitcase from Macy's?
Yes, this is the infamous.
Oh my god, that damn thing was very expensive.
You know how much money I made off this suitcase? Just
how much money did I make off of it?
You didn't make shit.
Yeah, well.
Hey Josh, here, you can have this. This will make the internet in your home better.
I don't know anything about this.
Alright, I'll hook it up somewhere. It's a Wi-Fi extender.
We got a Wi-Fi extender, boys. Ew. Wi-Fi extender.
Justin, you
got... What?
You got to become a registered voter in Florida.
Fuck it, dude.
Yeah, so you're going to vote in 2020
MX for tipped Trump $2. Don't worry, Linda. We love you here in chat.
You can vote for 20...
You didn't acknowledge the person that was talking to you?
Thank you so much. You can vote for 20 Trump in 2020, Justin.
Yes, yes. Josh. Where's Josh?
Both of you.
Here, look at that.
Be a goddamn independent bullshit. Get off of the fence. The fence is hurting you. Bandit!
No, nothing. Oh, you can?
This will make internet go throughout the entire house.
Where can I put this? It's a dedicated...
ask your brother.
Mold. I need to find a dedicated plug that you ain't gonna mess with, Lane.
Well, you can't leave your suitcase there with the band over the
end. Alright, I'm not talking about suitcase.
I am. Or the cabin, but I don't know.
Linda.
Justin.
Linda!
Ask your brother.
Well, maybe then convoys could now be looted
by Fox News dogs and nosies.
General submarines have to work harder and search further to find or sink their prey.
Hang on, chat.
Yes.
Some Trump 2020 signs you can stand out on the street corner.
Yeah, let's do it.
Fuck it. Where are those chips? Where are the chips? Where are the chips?
The chips. Where are the chips?
I don't have any chips.
The chips for this dip.
What are you eating the dip with?
Hello?
Hold on a minute. This is get that picked up.
Stop.
For the dog.
Stop.
Pees on it. No,
stop.
Justin.
I'm doing something.
I don't care if you're
doing I'm doing something. Give me a second. I'm doing something.
Alright, wait, this should be coming back.
Bandit.
I don't remember my fucking login. Oh, here's chips. Sorry, chat. Yes. Hang on, I'm going through it.
I know, that's right in the middle of the walkway.
Oh. This is cold.
Well, heat it up then. Throw it in the microwave.
Mm.
Still
spitting
up. Yeah. Huh? Spit what? What room out there? Yeah. I thought you were with that hamburger. Yeah.
Yeah, when you puree stuff, you have to add a little water. I used to work in a hospital, so I knew that.
Almost immediately.
You didn't do it enough. You got puree, like liquid almost. I used to puree Alistair's food. I thought
Alistair's
food.
No. Now, why would you put the top on it?
No,
put the top on it. You put the top on it. The orange top. No.
Put the orange top.
No, put the orange top on it. No. No.
The U.S. Navy's commander-in-chief, Admiral Ernest King, who assisted British advice to corral his merchant ships into conflict.
Fuck it, dude.
Over a 3-month period, more than 400 U.S. merchant ships were sunk or destroyed.
Jump, mama.
America was learning the tough lesson Britain had already learned.
What door? Because it's hot in there.
The microwave door.
Because it's hot.
No.
I'm always worried about what I'm doing. Just let people live. Damn. Just let people live. Fuck. Stop crying over spilt milk. Holy shit. Just let me be. Because I don't want them. It's hot out. So? Am I friend, am I bothering you watching fucking same shit you've seen 12 times already? Friend's already seen this. It's not like history changes. It's not like it's going to be different the next time you see it. He never said a damn word. Stop speaking for people.
Allied aircraft were fitted with a new high-powered searchlight, the Neon.
Imagine speaking for on behalf of someone else when they never say a goddamn word. You stop it because you're instigating. Stop and just stop instigating. Just leave me alone. She's instigating. Tell her to shut up and leave me alone. See where you started? You just can't leave me the fuck alone.
Justin!
Bro, Brett doesn't care what I do, chat. Just give a shot. I'm not doing anything. I'm standing here. British sent in extra support. Nell? Where's the flowers? Flowers, I want flowers. We're not back to World War. No?
What did I talk to you about?
I just saw, what did you tell her? You gotta tell her, don't talk to me. Yo, where's the weed? Where? You gave it to me, and I brought it back to you last night.
Give me a minute and let me look for it.
I'm going to go out back. Bring me some weed, homie. Come on, Nelly. Come on, Bandit. No, no.
Sound Station.
Hey, this is Carrie Underwood.
Hey, everybody, I'm Blake Shelton.
Hey, this is Luke Brown. We are Kiss Country 99.9.
Get ready for this week's Top 30. Hey, everybody, this is Garth Brooks, and we're doing these songs on the stage. I just released this song with Blake Shelton.
Out.
We'll play that song and talk about the stadium tour as I count down the kids with Lon Elton and Country Edge.
Right,
here's Lon with his Nelly song.
Frank Scarth and Aurea Stages give the honor to Thomas Rhett.
Come on, Nelly, let's go.
God gave her.
Bennett. Nelly, Bennett.
Ayo, happy summer. We are live on SJC on YouTube in sunny South Florida. Ayo, come and hang out. Yeah, always promoting this channel, boys. I stay promoting this channel. Fuck yeah, here we go. Yeah. My new shaker cup. My new shaker cup, boys. Fuck yeah. Look at this. Fuck yeah. Fuck it. Let's just dump the rest in. Wait, is that all that's left? There's a little bit left.
I'm joined by a top country star who stops by the studio to give me hand count down the hits. And back for the second week in a row, we have our very special guest. As part of our deal last week, I have to introduce him as Mr. Yearwood.
Yes. I feel important now.
I had to keep the promise. Anyway, last week you introduced your new single, a duet, of course, with Blake Shelton called Dive Bar. Yeah. And one reason that we wanted
to
celebrate.
How come the country singers don't like Old Town Road? How come they don't like Old Town Road? You know the song Old Town Road? No? I'm gonna take my horse to the Old Town Road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. No, Brent? Brent loves that song. Brent! Oh shit! Hi, puppy.
And interestingly enough, as it turns out, the song Dive Bar is actually in our top 30 this week.
Thank you.
SJC himself tipped $20.
Woo!
Dot stream.
Thank you.
Bro, thank you. Thank you for $20. Dude, I love you. Thank you. Oh, thank you, dude. Holy shit, bro. Thank you. Oh. Fuck it, dude. Fuck. I was drinking this G Fuel. And my new PewDiePie cup. My new PewDiePie shaker cup. Dude, I'm fucking excited. No, where'd you shit? I smell shit. Restart the stream? That's fucking lit. I want my G Fuel cup to be, to change colors. Whee! The audio's out of sync. Is the audio out of sync, boys? Audio. Audio. Fix my audio, it's not in sync. Bro, I don't know anything about it. I don't know anything. All right, I guess, should I start a new VOD? Should I start a new VOD? Should I end this VOD and start a new one, boys? Put a one in the chat. All right, we're gonna start a new VOD. I'm gonna end this one right here. We're gonna start a brand new VOD. New VOD. Ayo, new VOD. We're gonna save this one. If someone can be so kind to make me a thumbnail, I need a Florida thumbnail. I need one that says that I'm in Florida. I need one that says, like, I'm in Florida, I'm in sunshine. Someone make it, and it will be featured. We need a new thumbnail. Thumbnail. We need a new thumbnail. All right, boys. I will be back. I am your host, Skeff Jim Carrey. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. We will be right back.